Good morning all. On behalf of Department of ECE and my own behalf, and especially on behalf of AICT Pranana scheme, I welcome one and all present here for the effective coaching class, the training class. Over to Pradeep sir. Yes, sir, it is audible.
Okay, thank you. Yes, sir, whether I can start the session or we need to wait for 5 more minutes or anything.
Sir, we can wait up to 2 to 3 minutes, sir. We'll start the session after 3 minutes.
Okay, so good morning once again. So let's restart the session. So it's already 9:50. We can start the session. And I'm just going to present my screen. Please let me know once it is visible. hope it is, my screen is visible to everyone. Is it? Yes, okay, thank you. So, okay. So last class, we just go through some of the basic things. So that's the basic, what is current, what is voltage, and what is inductor capacitance, and classifications of circuit elements, and what is open circuit, and what is closed circuit, and what is short circuit. So we all come across these things, basic one. And the main part is, the main parameters, what is node and junction, branch, loop, mesh. Okay, so these are some of the important points we need to consider. And regarding what is Ohm's law, you know that V is equal to IR. So from that we can able to calculate the voltage or current or resistance values. Okay, so next we are moving into the session KCL and KVL. So we know that KCL is nothing but the incoming current is equal to outgoing current. Okay, so from this we can able to solve so many problems also. And in case of KVL, and in a closed circuit, the source voltage is equal to drop voltage. Okay, so that is the simple thing we can able to keep it in our mind. So the same thing, which will be applied for the KCL as well as KVL. So in current, incoming current is equal to outgoing current. In case KVL, source voltage is equal to voltage drop. That is the difference. Okay, so you just keep it in mind like this. Okay, so how the multiple source into single source, we just saw the thing. And resistor, which it is arranged in series or parallel. So how we can able to calculate the total resistance, either it is connected in series or parallel. Okay, and these are the things we just gone through that. And how the resistor can be combined. Okay, so if the circuit is given, and from that how total resistance can be calculated. Okay, so these are the things we can able to see. Hope you understand the concept of how the series and parallel resistor we can able to identify, whatever the complicated circuit it may be. Okay, so whether it is arranged in diagonal or whatever the things, if the both the resistor ends are connected. Okay, so that is the important point. If both the ends of the resistor are connected with each other, okay, so both the resistor end are connected with each other means that is parallel. Okay, so you can use it that, and whatever the circuit, wherever the circuit, and whatever the circuit, you can able to easily solve that thing. Okay, so you can able to identify whether it is parallel or series. Okay, so if the both the ends are not connected, if one end is connected and if another end is not connected with that particular resistor, means it is arranged in series. Okay, so keep it in mind like this. And and voltage division and current division. So we come across the formulas for voltage division. So if you are going to calculate for V1, means and total voltage into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, so this is the equation for the voltage division. And for current division, I1 is equal to I into opposite, that is parallelly arranged opposite resistor. Okay, so R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into I. Okay, so this is the voltage and current division equation. So from this we can also solve some problem also. Okay, by using this equation we can solve problems also. Okay, and how the source transformation. Okay, so we come across the thing, source transformation. So how the voltage series resistor source converted into current parallel resistance. Okay, so that is voltage to current source conversion. Okay, if the resistor as well as the voltage which will be connected in series, and we can easily convert that voltage source into current source. Okay, we need to convert. From that we can be able to calculate the current. Okay, we know the value of voltage and resistor, means from that we can able to calculate the current, and we can able to mention the current value, and parallelly the resistance should be placed. Okay, so that is the conversion. Okay, so source conversion from voltage to current, or current to voltage. Okay, and from that we can also solve see some basic problems also. And we just enter into the main section, mesh analysis. Okay, so already we know that what is mesh and what is loop. Okay, so loop is nothing but the what are the possible, most possible closed path we can able to acquire. Okay, so mesh is nothing but what is the what are all the closed path which will be arranged. Okay, so it doesn't combining any closed path condition. Okay, so that is called as the mesh. So we can able to solve the things also. So how the current can be calculated. Okay, so already I have mentioned that in regarding the KCL and KVL. So in case of KVL, we are just calculating the current. Okay, so if you are applying Kirchhoff voltage law, we can able to calculate current from that. Okay, so in case of KCL, if you are applying KCL, that is node analysis, means we can able to calculate in the voltage from that. Okay, so that is also keep it in mind. And we also see some of the how we can able to solve the mesh. Okay, so by calculating the current in that particular loop, and also seen about what is super mesh and how we can able to solve, and that are all the things we can we just saw in the last class. Okay, so next one is node analysis. Okay, so node analysis also we just saw it in that. We just point out the nodes. So what are all the possible nodes we can able to get from a circuit. Okay, and we can able to have one reference node, that is the ground, which is common to all the branches which will be connected. Okay, so only one ground node will be available for any of the circuit, and we can able to have the nodes. We can able to identify the nodes and what are the branches which should be connected with that thing. Okay, so two or more branches can be connected in a node. Okay, so that is mentioning as a node. Okay, and from that also we can identify the nodes, and we just solve how the voltage can be calculated from that particular node. Okay, so V1 or V2 or V3, whatever it may be, we can calculate in the node with that. Okay, and super node also we have just shown in that thing. And what is the node? And next one we just saw the star to delta transformation. Okay, so star to delta transformation, we have seen the formula. So how the star to delta can be converted, and what is the formula for that, and how the delta to star conversion, and what is the formula for that. Okay, so delta to star means we just see this formula. Okay, so Ra is equal to, if it is representing the resistor A, means in the numerator we must mention the availability of A resistor. Okay, so that is, if it is Ra means we just in the numerator we just want to mention RAB, in that also A available, and into RAC. Okay, so in RBC we don't have any A resistor value, so we don't mentioning in the numerator, and at the denominator we just add all the possible resistors present in this. Okay, so this is how you can able to memorize the formula for this. Okay, and in case of star to delta, so in case of star to delta, the same procedure it can able to apply for this also. If you are calculating RAB, means in the numerator we just want to have the resistor value A as well as B. We don't want to any C resistor present in the numerator. Okay, so like that we can also have a hint in this. Okay, so RAB is equal to RA plus RB plus RAB divided by RC. In the denominator only the C resistor will be available. Likewise for the RBC. Okay, in the numerator we are just having the B resistor as well as the C resistor. In the denominator only we are having the A resistor. Okay, so on that like you can just have a hint in your mind. And we just solved the conversion also, how the conversion can be made, how the star can be converted into delta, and how the delta can be converted into star. Okay, so this is one of the gate question. We just see the thing. Okay, and so this is also some of the conversion we have saw in the last minutes. Okay, so this is the thing we have just gone through it. Okay, so hope you just solve the problems you have. I just give it in for homework. Okay, so if you can able to solve that thing, it is somewhat easy to solve all the related things. Okay, so that is the basic circuits I have given to you. So if you have get the idea, how can able to proceed? Okay, if you get the idea, means that is enough. Okay, so whatever the circuits which they have provided, we just want to know what method we can able to proceed. So whatever the method you can able to proceed, you can get the answer. Okay, but in how many time efficient? Okay, so how we can able to solve that circuit or solve that problem within a short duration? Okay, so that is very important. Okay, so that's what we need to calculate. Either you can able to go for mesh analysis or either you can go for nodal analysis. It's nothing matter, but how we can able to choose that particular thing. So if you are choosing that particular thing, means we just want to solve it in very short duration. So that is very much important for the problem solving analysis. Okay, so we just see laterally what are all the problems we have given it for homework, and we just saw how idea you can able to get from that. Okay, so before that, we just finished the things Thevenin's and Norton's theorem. So hope you have idea about this. Okay, so what is Thevenin's theorem and what is Norton's theorem? Okay, so this is one of the important topics also present in this. So yeah, so Thevenin's theorem means we just want to calculate the total voltage, that is the Thevenin's voltage we are going to calculate in a circuit, whether it is a linear circuit. So it is purely we are going to calculate for the linear circuits. Okay, so linear circuits, we are just calculating the Thevenin's voltage by connecting load. So after removing the load only, we can able to calculate the V Thevenin. Okay, so once we are going moving into the problem, means we can able to see the thing. Okay, so if you are having any load resistor RL, means we just want to remove that load resistor and we are going to calculate in the total voltage from that. Okay, so sorry, back into this. If you are going to calculating the Thevenin's voltage, okay, so we just want to remove the load resistor and we are just calculating the what is the voltage present in that circuit. Okay, so that is the Thevenin's voltage we can able to calculate. And in case of Thevenin's resistor, okay, so in case of Thevenin's resistor, if you want to calculate a Thevenin resistor for a circuit, means we just want to keep it in mind, we just want to short the voltage source and open the current source. Okay, so please have a note as well as the pen in your hand, and we can able to solve this thing. Okay, so for calculating the Thevenin's resistor, short the voltage source as well as the open the current source. This is the thing we need to keep in mind. Okay, so then only if the circuit only having the resistor only. Okay, so then we are going to calculate the total resistance value, that is the Thevenin's resistance. Okay, so once we move into the problem, you can able to understand. Okay, so this is the steps to find out the voltage Thevenin as well as the resistor Thevenin. Okay, so VTH, likewise the RTH. Okay, so in case of calculating the Thevenin's voltage, okay, so remove the load resistance, mark the terminal as A and B, find the open circuit voltage. Okay, so that is the open circuit voltage we are going to calculate, that is the V Thevenin. Okay, so in case of Thevenin's resistance, okay, so remove the load resistor and mark the terminal as A and B and kill the resistance, that is remove the source resistance, and voltage source is replaced by short circuit. Okay, and current source is replaced by open circuit. From that we are going to calculate the equivalent resistance value. Okay, so RTH is nothing but the equivalent resistance value. Okay, so how the resistor will be connected, we are going to solve and find the equivalent resistance, whether it is serial or parallel condition. Okay, so these are the points we are going to find out the Thevenin's voltage and resistance value. Okay, So once we have calculated the Thevenin's voltage and Thevenin's resistance, we can able to calculate the load current. Okay. So VTH is the Thevenin's voltage. By this procedure, we can solve this thing. And RTH is the equivalent resistance. By this procedure, we have solved the resistance value. Okay. After that, we just want to connect that particular load resistance. Okay. Well, the load resistance in the chapter, we just connect after finding the VTH and RTH. Okay. So from this, we can able to calculate the load current. What is the load current which will be flowing through the resistor? For this, we are having the formula IL is equal to VTH divided by RTH plus RL. Okay, so VTH already we just derived from the procedure, and RTH also we just derived from the procedure, and RL is the given data which will be provided in this problem. Okay, so only given problem will be given RL. So from that, we can easily calculate the load current. So load current is nothing but the current which will be flowing into the load. Okay, but the load resistance like how much current goes up here, then from that we can able to calculate. Okay, so this is the procedure for finding the Thevenin's resistance as well as Thevenin's voltage and load resistance. Sorry, load current. Okay, so hope you have some idea regarding this, and we just move into the problem. Okay, and this is the problem. So we are having the source voltage as 50 volt and the resistor 5 ohm, 20 ohm, 4 ohm, and the terminal is given as AB. Okay, so this is the load resistance. R is the load resistance. So if you want to find out the voltage Thevenin, that is Thevenin voltage means, what we want to do? So first we are going to calculate the Thevenin's voltage. For this, what we want to do? So just unmute and tell the answer. Procedure lena paatho. Anyone?
Have to remove load resistance.
Yeah, we have to remove the load resistance, and we need to find out the open circuit voltage. Okay, so we just want to remove this resistance value, and from this, what is the open circuit voltage which will be present? That is the Thevenin's voltage. Okay, so that is the procedure we are going to solve. Okay, so first we are going to calculate the Thevenin's voltage. Okay, so we are just removing the load resistance. Okay, RL remove only wrong, just take it as A and B terminal. Okay, so we need to find out the current which will be flowing through this mesh. Okay, so in the mesh la vandu enna current flow aagudhu therinjadha vandu we can able to calculating the voltage. Okay, since it is the open circuit, there will not be any flow of current will be takes place. Okay, so adu correct thana? So open circuit irukanaala indha idhila vandu no current will be flowing. Okay, so upon the 4 ohm resistance vandu it doesn't matter, idha vera nama consider pannikida vendam. Okay va, so we know that if we want to calculating the voltage, okay, so or rendu resistance parallel la connect a irundichu appadina oru voltage oru resistance ku across a voltage kandupidichom appadina the same voltage will be flowing across that particular voltage also, because voltage vandu parallel வந்து எப்படி இருக்கும் voltage flow வந்து voltage drop across the parallel resistance வந்து எப்படி இருக்கும்
same
இருக்கும். ஓகேவா, so that is the thing. Okay, so அதனால இங்க இருந்து நம்ம voltage output open circuit voltage கண்டுபிடிக்கணும் அப்படினா, so what is the voltage drop across 20 ohm? If you find that, we can able to get the that is the V Thevenin. Okay, so இதுக்கு அக்ராஸா நமக்கு வந்து ஓபன் சர்க்யூட்ல வோல்டேஜ் கிடைக்கணும். இங்க வந்து ஏற்கனவே ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் பேரலலா கனெக்ட் ஆயிருக்கு. சோ அப்ப இங்க என்ன வோல்டேஜ் டிராப் இருக்கோ தட் மச் வோல்டேஜ் will be we can able to receive here also. Okayவா? So this is the procedure we are going to follow. Okayவா? So since it is opened at terminal A and B, no current will be flowing through the resistor. Hence the voltage across 20 ohm will be the voltage across the terminal tap. Okay, so this is the point we need to habit in mind. Okay, so namage ermey therinjadha. So it is not a new thing. We know that the voltage which will be flowing in the parallel resistor, it is same. Likewise, the current which will be flowing in the parallel resistor, it is different. Okay, so that is the basic thing. We just want to keep it in mind at any time also. Okay, so for this we just want to calculate in the voltage drop. Okay, so voltage drop on the another kandupidikano. For that we just want to find out the total current. Okay, so total current enada abingiradhu vandu find out panna dhaan vandu what is the voltage drop across 20 ohm abingiradhu vandu we can able to calculate. Okay, so for this we are just applying the KCL. Okay, so KCL apply panni we can able to calculate the current. Sorry, KVL apply panni current vandu calculate pandrom. So I is equal to V by R. So that is the source voltage V. So these two resistors are connected in series. Okay, so series are connected here, that is 25. So our total current I is equal to 50 divided by 25, that is the 2 ampere. Okay, so that is the total current which will be flowing in this mesh. Okay, so this is the current that will flow or things. Okay, so here is the voltage drop across 20 resistor, nothing but the current, same current will be series அப்படிங்கறனால நமக்கு வந்து கரண்ட் ஃப்ளோயிங் வந்து என்ன இருக்கும் சோ தி சேம் கரண்டா இருக்கும் சோ அதனால பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா 2 into 20 that is 40 volt ஓகேவா சோ இதுல எந்த டவுட் இருக்காது நினைக்கிறேன் சோ சிம்பிளா just we are calculating the thing சோ சீரிஸ் ரெசிஸ்டர் அப்படிங்கறனால கரண்ட் ஃப்ளோயிங் வந்து சேமா தான் இருக்கும் சோ அப்ப அந்த I கரண்ட் தான் வந்து இங்கேயும் ஃப்ளோ ஆகும் சோ I into R ஓகேவா சோ தட் இஸ் 2 into 20 that is 40 voltage that is the total Thevenin's voltage we can able to have okay so namak yerkane theriyum so in the terminal ku across a voltage enna irukano appadina the 20 ohm ku across a enna voltage drop the same thing will be we can able to receive it here okay so that is the total Thevenin's voltage okay so idhula edho doubt irukadhu nenikiren okay so next we are going to calculating the RTH Thevenin's so resistance Thevenin's resistance okay so for that we know the procedure we just want to short the sources voltage source irundichu appadina adha vandu short pannirom okay va adhe edhu current source irundichu appadina we just want to open circuit adha vandu cut panni uttrom adhula theriyala illa adhula short panna venda open circuit ah make panni utta that is enough okay va so appo inge pathinga idhula yarkane oru voltage resistance irundichu sorry source voltage irundichu adha vandu short circuit ah maatittu remaining irukra resistance structure ah appadiye vandu draw panni vechirukom okay va so from this we can able to calculate the R equivalent okay va so R equivalent is nothing but the Thevenin's resistor so just tell me what is the R equivalent for this circuit the resistor circuit in the circuit is what is the R equivalent Don't need to use the chat box. Just unmute yourself and tell the answer.
Four ohm.
Four ohm or da? Okay. So, ellar kada da? Yar me different aur da?
சரி 8 ஓம்
8 ஓம் ஓகே சோ 8 ஓம் எல்லாருக்கும் வந்திருக்கா சோ தட் இஸ் தி கரெக்ட் ஆன்சர் சோ சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் யூ नीड टू see it from here ஓகே சோ whenever you are calculating the Thevenin's voltage you just from the start from the opposite to the open circuit எங்க இருக்கோ அந்த இடத்துக்கு opposite ல இருந்து you just want to calculate சோ இது ரெண்டையும் பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா you can able to understand So, one end vandu one end oda connect a irukku, adutha end vandu adutha end oda resistance connect a irukku. So, it is parallel. Okay, so 20 into 5 means that is 100 divided by 20 plus 5, 25. So, divided by 100 divided by 25 means that is 4. Okay, appo 4 nu varum. So, idu rendu me vandu it will be connected in series. So, 4 plus 4, it is 8. So that is the RTH is equal to 8 ohm. So this is simple thing. So hope all will understand the things. Okay. So once we just find out the V Thevenin's as well as the R Thevenin. Okay. So we just want to calculate in the load current. Okay. So for this, we just want to redraw the circuit. Okay. Just mention one source voltage and just mention one resistance. That is the source voltage is nothing but the Thevenin's voltage. 40 volt, likewise, R Thevenin is nothing but the 8 ohm. After that, we just want to add the load resistance which will be removed at the starting. Okay, so V Thevenin kandupidikiradhukku, R Thevenin kandupidikiradhukku, we just remove the load resistance. Okay, va? So adha remove pannirukom. So and the load resistance vandu finally we need to attach at the end. Okay, va? So adhe edathula vandu attach pannikirom by having Thevenin's voltage and Thevenin's resistance. So, from the circuit la connect panite, from this we need to calculate the load current. Okay, load current vendu appingara vandu find out pannom. So, it is simple thing. Okay, so I is equal to V by R. So, total Thevenin's voltage vandu IL equal to VTH divided by RTH plus RL. Okay, so VTH value namakku theriyum 40, RTH it is 8 ohm and RL it is 2 ohm. Okay, so from this easily calculating the load current. Okay, so this how we can able to expect some problems also. So we don't expecting all of the thing, they are asked all of the things to calculate. Either they may ask the to calculate the Thevenin's voltage or Thevenin's resistance or what is the load current. So like that we can able to expect the questions. Okay, so this is one of the simple circuit. So we can also expect some circuit which is complex also. Okay, so we can also have the current source also present in the circuit and we can also expect that thing also. Okay, so hope there will not be any queries in this problem by calculating VTH and RTH. So in the problem so this is the basic procedure. Okay, so basic procedure nala, first procedure we just want to identify what is the procedure and we just want to implement that procedure. That is the thing. Okay, so procedure namakku purinjichanaale vandu, so whatever the circuit may be, we can able to solve it easy. Okay, so if there is no problem, we can move into the next one. What is the voice romba low a iruka? So ipo correct a iruka voice? Jason Agalia. Okay, so thank you. Okay, so next we solve another problem. And the problem is find the Thevenin's equivalent circuit for the given circuit and also find the voltage across load resistance, the same thing. Okay, so this is one of the next model problem. Okay, so here we are also having the voltage source as well as the current source also present in this. Okay, so this is another one model. We can also expect like this also. Okay, so first we need to find out the VTH. Okay, so for that VTH, we just want to remove the load resistance. Load resistance means which will be connected across the A and B. Okay, so we just want to remove this load resistance, that is 17 ohm. We just want to remove, then only we can calculate in the Thevenin's voltage as well as the Thevenin's current. Okay, so we can remove the section like this. Okay, so from this we just want to calculate in the VOC, that is the open circuit voltage. Okay, that is also called as VTH. Okay, so in the edathula pathinga appadina here we can also take it as one mesh and this is also one mesh. Okay, so அப்ப இதுல வோல்டேஜ் இத நம்ம கண்டுபிடிக்கணும் அப்படினா here there will not be any current flowing. ஏனா ஓபன் சர்க்யூட்ல இருக்குது, கரண்ட் ஃப்ளோயிங் இருக்காது. So இதுல வந்து வோல்டேஜ் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும் அப்படினா we just want to know the voltage across 20 ohm and also know the voltage across 10 ohm. Okay, so அத ரெண்டையும் ஆட் பண்ணா what is the voltage value means, that is the total Thevenin's voltage. Okay, va puinjirukku nenikiren. So idhula enna appadina anga vandu pathinga indha idu irundirukku. Okay va, so current vandu irundirukku. So we just dispose the value. Okay va, 4 ohm irundhuchu nenikiren, adu dispose pannirukom. So here we are having the current flowing in this also. Likewise here also we are having the current flow. Okay, so appo indha rendu resistance ku across a enna voltage irukko and the voltage add panna, that is the Thevenin's voltage. Okay, so hope you understand like this. Okay, so okay, so that is the thing. So VTH or VOC is equal to voltage across 20 plus voltage across 10 ohm. Okay, so this is the thing we are going to calculate. Okay, so for this we just want to calculate in the I. Okay, so what is the current flowing through this, and current flowing here we are having the current as mentioned. Okay, so 1.5 ampere already they have mentioned. So easily we can calculate in the voltage across this 10 ohm. Okay, so V is equal to I into R, 1.5 into 10. So that is the thing here they have mentioned. Okay, so for this voltage across 20 ohm we just want to calculate in the volt current first. Okay, so current kandupidikkanum na namakku theriyum I is equal to V by R. So 20 divided by, so rendu resistance series la connect a irukku, 20 divided by 25. Okay, so that is the current value, that is 0.8 we can able to get. Okay, so that's the current, total current flowing in this source is 0.8 current, okay, ampere. So the same current will be flowing through the 5 ohm as well as the 20 ohm. Okay, so we want to calculate in the 20 ohm what is the voltage drop across this. Okay, so 0.8 into 20. Okay, so in the wording puriyirukku nenikiren idu. Okay va, so idhula irundhu total current inga irundhu flow aara current enna kandupidichirukom, 0.8 V by R. Okay va, simple thing da. So the same series resistance nala same current will be flowing. So idhukku across a enna voltage varumna, I into R. So I value vandu 0.8, kuduthukku resistance value vandu 20. So adhe maari indha idhula paathinga they have mentioned the current also already. Okay va, current e kuduthutanga. So appo the 10 ohm liya flow aara current vandu 1.5. So from this we can calculate the voltage, 1.5 into 10. Totally if you are adding this thing we can able to get the 31 volt. Okay va, so idhula edho yaarukku doubt irukka nu nenikiren, yaarukku doubt edho irukka? Okay, so if it is not doubt, we are just moving into the RTH. Okay, so we are going to calculating the RTH value. Okay, so we know that we are to find the Thevenin's resistance, we just want to short circuit the voltage and open circuit the current. Okay va, so in the circuit appa irukken idhula irundhu enna pannum appadina RTH kandupidikkanum, already nam resistance load resistance remove pannadukku apuram இதுல வந்து resist source resistance, that is source voltage வந்து we just want to make it as short circuit. Okay va, so இதுல வந்து அப்படியே resistor எடுத்துட்டு இது ரெண்டையும் கனெக்ட் பண்ணி விட்டுருங்க. அதே இது source current இருந்துச்சு அப்படினா we just want to open circuit. அப்போ இந்த பாயிண்ட் அப்படியே வந்து எடுத்து விட்டோம் அப்படினா it will be available as a open circuit one. So this is the structure. Source இருந்தது short circuit ஆகிட்டோம், current இருந்தது வந்து sorry voltage இருந்தது short circuit ஆகிட்டோம், current இருந்தது வந்து open circuit ஆகிடும். Okay va, so from this we need to calculate the RTH. RTH என்ன வருது சொல்லுங்க பாப்போம். yeah that's right. Okay va, so ரெண்டுமே வந்து series parallel ல இருக்குது, 5 ohm 20 ohm parallel connection ல இருக்குது. So 100 divided by 25, so முன்னாடி பார்த்தோம்னு நினைக்கிறேன் 4 னு வரும். So 4 plus 10. Okay va, so 4 and 10 series ல connect ஆயிருக்கும், that is 14 RTH. Okay va, so RTH VTH கண்டுபிடிச்சாச்சு, அதுல இருந்து ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலா we can calculate the என்னது, so load current. Okay va, load current வந்து ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலா we can able to calculate. So VTH that is 31 ohm, RTH 14 ohm, so we can calculate the IL. So IL is equal to VTH divided by RTH plus RL. Okay, so we know the all the values VTH, RTH, RL. From that easily we can calculate the load current. Okay, so this how we can expect the problems. Okay, so this is the maximum things. Okay, so in the area, no doubts will like the problem na. Anyone having any doubts? Any doubts in this problem? Okay. So if you have any doubt, means you just stop me right there and you can ask the questions. Okay, so no problem with that. So this is the next model and the same thing. Okay, so we are having the voltage source as well as the current source. Okay, so sometimes they have mentioned like this also. So understand like you know, A B terminal kudutu avungale vandu open ah vittutanga appadina we don't want to remove the load resistor yana ab terminal da namak epovume vandu load la connect a irukum so ala ab nu kandipa kuduthirupanga appadi illana di extend panni vittu open panni uttaanga appadina we don't want to remove any resistor value okay va already they have given it as an open circuit only okay va so idha mind la epovume vechukonga so load resistor kuduthu ab terminal kuduthu ala or resistor kuduthirundanga na we need to remove it manually. Okay, otherwise if they have given open circuited as AB அப்படிங்கிற மாதிரி ஓபனா அவங்களே கொடுத்துட்டாங்கன்னா there will not be any load resistance in that. Okay, அது load resistance ஏ கிடையாது. சோ அத வந்து நம்மளும் எதுவும் ரிமூவ் பண்ண வேண்டாம். As it is we just going to calculate the VTH and RTH. Okay, va. So this is one of the important points we need to consider. சரியா? The point mind la vechukonga okay va so first we need to calculate the VTH okay va so VTH kandupidikanum so we need to calculate the VTH means so whatever the voltage drop across 60 ohm okay va so idhukku across a enna voltage irukudo adha namakku automatically namakku VTH nu namakku theriyum okay va ena it will be connected in parallel ore or resistor da parallel la connect a irukku so we can easily find it okay va so appa enna na whatever the current which will be flowing through the 60 ohm adha mattum nama vandu calculate panna podum easy ah we can finish the or find out the VTH value okay va so adhukku enna pannum we are having the so we are having the current as parallel one that is common to the this mesh as well as the this mesh okay va so இப்போ என்ன அப்படினா நம்ம வந்து கரண்ட் கண்டுபிடிச்சி நம்ம வந்து இதுக்கு அக்ராஸா கண்டுபிடிக்கிறதுக்கு வந்து so வோல்டேஜ் கண்டுபிடிக்கிறதுனால என்னன்னா we are having multiple points multiple nodes இருக்கனால we are just proceeding with the node analysis okay va ஏனா நமக்கு இந்த பாயிண்ட்ல மட்டும் தான் நமக்கு வந்து what is the voltage அப்படிங்கறது வந்து நமக்கு தெரியும் 60 ஓம்க்கு அக்ராஸா மட்டும் தான் நமக்கு வந்து we just want to calculate the value okay va so அதனால வந்து we don't want to bother about the remaining things okay va so இந்த இடத்துல உள்ளது நாம வந்து டைம் வேஸ்ட் பண்ண வேண்டாம் okay va so இதுல என்ன ஃப்ளோ ஆகுது அப்படிங்கறது வந்து பார்த்து நம்ம வந்து டைம் வேஸ்ட் பண்ண வேண்டாம் so we are applying the node analysis to calculating the voltage across the 60 ohm okay va so அதான் வந்து கொடுத்திருப்பாங்க so whatever the branches which will be connected in the V2 okay va so node 2 ல வந்து என்னெல்லாம் வந்து branches connect ஆயிருக்கோ அத எல்லாமே வந்து we just going to write okay va so இதல முன்னாடி பார்த்தாலே நமக்கு தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும் so இதல இருந்து V2 ல இருந்து என்னெல்லாம் connect ஆயிருக்குன்னு பாருங்க okay va so V2 ல இருந்து ஒரு ground க்கு போகுது so அதே மாதிரி V2 ல இருந்து அடுத்த ground க்கு ஒன்னு போகுது so இது வழியா okay va so இது வழியா ஒரு ground க்கு போகுது so அதுக்கு அடுத்து V1 க்கு connect ஆயிருக்கு so மூணு பாயிண்ட் வந்து நமக்கு வந்து இருக்கு okay va so V2 ல இருந்து branches எங்கெல்லாம் போகுதுன்னு பாத்தீங்கனா V2 ல இருந்து V1 க்கு ஒரு பாயிண்ட் ஓகேவா சோ இது ஒரு பாயிண்ட் சோ அதுக்கு அடுத்து V3 B2 ல இருந்து அப்படியே இங்க வரும்போது டைரக்டா கிரவுண்டுக்கு தான் வருது எல்லாமே கனெக்ட் ஆயி ஓகேவா சோ அதே மாதிரி இதுல பாக்கும்போது we are just connected with ground சரியா அப்ப இந்த மூணு இதையும் நம்ம வந்து எழுதினா அதுல இருந்து B2 வந்து ஈஸியா கண்டுபிடிச்சிரலாம் ஓகேவா சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கிரவுண்ட் குள்ளது பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா B2 -0 ஓகேவா கிரவுண்ட் வேல்யூ வந்து 0 B2 -0 divided by 60 plus 20 ரெண்டுமே சீரிஸ்ல கனெக்ட் ஆயிருக்கு சோ அதனால 60 plus 20 அப்போ divided by 18 ஓகேவா so next one B2 this one okay va so in the branch eduthukitinga appadina okay va so B2 30 already or 30 ohm 30 volt vandu namakku vandu connect a irukku okay va so it will be flowing in the negative to positive current will be flowing okay va so adula irundhu paathom appadina B2 minus 30 okay va so on the 30 ohm divided by or 40 ohm resistance vandu connect a irukku ஓகேவா சோ இதல வந்து பாத்தீங்கன்னா 40 ஓம் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் கனெக்ட் ஆயிருக்கு சோ அதுல இருந்து we can able to derive this ஓகேவா சோ B2 -30 divided by 40 ஓம் ஓகேவா சோ ஃபைனலா வந்து பாத்தீங்கன்னா ஒரு கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ் வந்திருக்கு ஓகேவா சோ இட் will be moving towards the பாசிட்டிவ் ஓகேவா சோ நெகட்டிவ்ல இருந்து moving towards the பாசிட்டிவ் அப்ப equal to அந்த சைடு போடும்போது இட் will be mentioned as +1.5 ஓகேவா -2 ப்ளஸ் தான் வந்து கரண்ட் ஃப்ளோயிங் டைரக்ஷன் கொடுத்திருக்காங்க அப்படிதானே சோ இது வந்து ப்ளஸ்ல கொடுத்திருக்காங்க சோ இதுல இருந்து வந்துச்சு அப்படினாலும் நெகட்டிவ் டு பாசிட்டிவ் கிரவுண்ட் டு பாசிட்டிவ் தான் நமக்கு வந்து ஃப்ளோ ஆயிட்டு இருக்குது சோ ஈக்குவல் டு அந்த சைடு போடும்போது ஓகே சோ ஈக்குவல் டு இந்த சைடு மென்ஷன் பண்ணும்போது we need to mention as +1.5 ஓகேவா சோ அப்ப இத சால்வ் பண்ணா we can able to calculate the voltage V2 ஓகேவா சோ இதெல்லாம் வந்து சிம்பிளா நம்ம வந்து ஐடென்டிஃபை பண்ண வேண்டியது நமக்கு தெரியும் ஓகேவா சோ இதல இருந்து பாத்தீங்கன்னா தட் இஸ் தி நோட் வோல்டேஜ் அக்ராஸ் தி பாயிண்ட் V2 ஓகேவா சோ V2 க்கு அக்ராஸா நமக்கு வந்து என்ன நோட் அப்படிங்கறத வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணிட்டோம் சோ அதுல இருந்து நமக்கு வந்து 60 ஓம் க்கு அக்ராஸா என்ன வோல்டேஜ் வருது அப்படிங்கறத வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணிக்கலாம் ஓகேவா சோ அப்ப இந்த டோட்டலா வந்து 60 ஓம் க்கு அக்ராஸா வரும்போது சோ I into ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ 60 நமக்கு தெரியும் சோ I கரண்ட் வந்து பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா சோ V2 -0 ஓகேவா சோ கிரவுண்ட் தான் நமக்கு போகுது V2 -0 டிவைடட் பை 60 plus 20 சோ அதுல இருந்து நமக்கு வந்து என்னது வோல்டேஜ் அக்ராஸ் தி 60 ஓம் வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணிக்கலாம் ஓகேவா சோ இதல கரண்ட் ஃப்ளோயிங் இந்த இதல தான் நமக்கு வந்து மெயினா பார்க்கணும் ஓகேவா சோ இந்த இதல மெயினா பாக்கும்போது கரண்ட் ஃப்ளோயிங் I is equal to V/R ஓகேவா சோ டோட்டல் வோல்டேஜ் வந்து V2 நமக்கு தெரியும் சோ அத வச்சு நம்ம வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணி ஃபைனல் ஆன்சர் என்ன வருதுங்கறத வந்து மென்ஷன் பண்ணிடுவோம் ஓகேவா சோ இந்த V2 க்கு பதிலா we are just placing 60 ஓகேவா இங்க ஏற்கனவே V2 கண்டுபிடிச்சிருக்கோம் சோ அந்த 60 ஐ மென்ஷன் பண்ணோம் 60 plus 20 னா 80 சோ அப்ப 60 into 60 divided by 80 சோ அதுல இருந்து 45 வோல்ட் அப்படிங்கறது வந்து இந்த 60 ஓம் க்கு அக்ராஸா நமக்கு வந்து வோல்டேஜ கண்டுபிடிக்கும் ஓகேவா சோ VOC is nothing but the VTH சரியா சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் என்னன்னா நல்லா அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் பண்ணிக்கோங்க we are just calculating the node point ஓகேவா சோ இந்த நோட்ல தான் வந்து வோல்டேஜ் என்ன இருக்கு அப்படிங்கறத வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணிருக்கோம் ஓகேவா சோ we need to calculating the voltage across 60 ohm 60 ohm க்கு across என்ன வந்திருக்கு என்ன வோல்டேஜ் இருக்கு டிராப் இருக்கு அப்படிங்கறத தான் நம்ம வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணனும் சோ for that only we are just moving another step ஓகேவா சோ another step 60 ohm க்கு across what is the voltage drop அப்படிங்கறத வந்து we are just calculating ஓகேவா சோ is there any doubt in this point like for calculating the VTH okay so there is no doubt means we just proceed for the RTH okay va so RTH you just calculate idhukku neengale calculate panni enna varum solunga paapom I just drawing this thing okay va so from this we just want to rearrange the terms okay voltage source enna pannanum current source enna pannanum nu vandu rearrange panni RTH value enna adun enna solunga paapom What is the value of RTH? Anyone find out that? Anyone find out, please unmute yourself and tell me. முடிச்சிங்களா
16.7
ஓம் 16.7 ஓம் ஆ என்ன வருது பாப்போம் 30 ஓம் வருது யாருக்கு வந்திருக்கா ஓ இது கொஞ்சம் நான் சொல்லித்தரேன் லைட்டாக இது கவனிங்க கொஞ்சம் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் தான் ஓகேவா ஸோ இதில் என்னன்னா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் தி திங் ஓகேவா ஸோ இதில் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா சோர்ஸை வந்து நம்ம வந்து ஷார்ப் பண்ணிட்டோம் ஓகேவா ஸோ ஷார்ப் பண்ணியாச்சு கரண்ட் சோர்ஸை வந்து ரிமூவ் பண்ணிட்டோம் அப்போ இங்கே வந்து ஒன்றுமே இருக்காது ஒரு லைனே நமக்கு வந்து இருக்காது சரியா அப்போ பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா ஸோ ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்டார்ட் ஃப்ரம் தி ஆப்போசிட் டு தி ஓப்பன் லைன் ஓகேவா ஸோ ஓப்பன் சர்க்யூட்டுக்கு ஆப்போசிட்லேருந்து வாங்க ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கன்சிடர் தீஸ் டூ திங் 25 and 5 ஓகேவா ஸோ இது ரெண்டுமே நமக்கு வந்து எப்படி இருக்கு ஸோ இது ஷார்ட் பண்ணனால இட் வில் பி கனெக்டட் இன் பேரலல் ஓகேவா ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் கனெக்டட் இன் பேரலல் ஸோ இது ரெண்டும் பேரலல் ஆனதுக்கு அப்புறம் ஸோ நமக்கு என்ன ஆன்சர் வரும் 25 × 5 / 13 வரும் ஸோ சம்திங் ஏதோ ஒரு ஆன்சர் வருது அந்த ஆன்சரை வந்து இதில் மென்ஷன் பண்ணிக்கோங்க ஓகேவா ஸோ அதுக்கடுத்தது 40 ஓம் So 40 ohm இதும் பாத்தீங்க அப்படின்னா இட் வில் பி கனெக்டட் இன் சீரீஸ் ஓகேவா ஸோ இது ரெண்டையும் கனெக்ட் பண்ணதுக்கு அப்புறம் நமக்கு ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ வரும் அந்த ரெசிஸ்டர் இதுல கொடுத்துருக்கேன் ஸோ அடுத்தது வந்து 40 ohm வருது 40 ohm வந்து என்னது இட் வில் பி கனெக்டட் இன் சீரீஸ் வித் திஸ் ஓகேவா அப்ப இது ரெண்டும் கனெக்ட் ஆனதுக்கு அப்புறமும் நமக்கு ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ வரும் இது ரெண்டையும் ஆட் பண்ணதுக்கு அப்புறம் நமக்கு வந்து ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ வரும் ஸோ அதுவும் இந்த வேல்யூ நமக்கு வந்து என்னது சீரீஸா கனெக்ட் ஆயிருக்கும் ஓகேவா ஸோ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆகுதா ஸோ அதுவும் இந்த 60 ஓம் ஸோ தட் இஸ் இந்த 60 ஓமும் ஸோ இது எல்லாம் சால்வ் பண்ணதுக்கு அப்புறம் ஸோ இது ரெண்டும் பேரலல் ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ வரும் அதுவும் இந்த 40 ஓமும் வந்து என்னது சீரீஸ் ஸோ இந்த இதில் வரதும் இதுவும் வந்து என்னது சீரீஸாக இருக்கும் ஸோ அதனால அதை வந்து என்ன பண்ணுறோம் ப்ளஸ் பண்ணுறோம் ஸோ அதுக்கடுத்தது பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா இந்த இடத்துல ஒன்றுமே இருக்காது அதனால பிரச்சனை இல்லை ஸோ இங்கே வரும்போது இங்கேயும் ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் இருக்கும் இதில் எல்லாம் கம்பைன் ஆகி இது எல்லாம் கம்பைன் ஆகி ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ நமக்கு இருக்கும் அந்த வேல்யூவும் இந்த ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ என்னது சீரீஸ்ல இருக்கும் அது ரெண்டையும் பிளஸ் பண்ணிக்கோங்க ஓகேவா ஸோ திஸ் ஒன் அண்ட் திஸ் ஒன் வந்து நமக்கு வந்து சீரீஸ்ல இருக்கும் அதை பிளஸ் பண்ணிக்கோங்க ஃபைனலா இது எல்லாம் கம்பைன் ஆனதுக்கு அப்புறம் இதுல ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ இதுல ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ 20 வரும் இது ரெண்டும் பேரல்ல இருக்கும் ஸோ அதை சால்வ் பண்ணீங்கன்னா நமக்கு வந்து ஃபைனல் ஆன்சர் வந்து கிடைக்கும் புரிஞ்சிருக்கும்னு நினைக்கிறேன் இன்னொரு கவுன் சொல்றேன் பார்த்துக்கோங்க ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வந்து சோர்ஸ் ரெசிஸ்டர் வந்து என்னது நம்ம வந்து என்னது ஷார்ட் சர்க்யூட் பண்ணியாச்சு கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ் வந்து சாரி வோல்டேஜ் சோர்ஸ் வந்து ஷார்ட் பண்ணியாச்சு கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ் வந்து வி ஜஸ்ட் நெக்லெக்ட் அப்ப இந்த இதுல கனெக்ஷனே இருக்காது இந்த ஊர்ல லைனே இருக்காது ஓகேவா சோ அதனால ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கோங்க இப்போ சோ இந்த லைனே நமக்கு வந்து என்னது இருக்காது இந்த லைன் இல்லாம நமக்கு சர்க்யூட் வந்து ரீஅரேஞ்ச் ஆறது வந்து எப்படி இருக்கும் இப்படி தான் ரீஅரேஞ்ச் ஆயிருக்கும் ஓகேவா அப்ப என்ன பண்ணோம் அப்படினா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் யூ ஜஸ்ட் கன்சிடர் these two ரெசிஸ்டர் ஓகேவா இட் will be connected in parallel ஓகேவா சோ இந்த எண்ட் இது கூட கனெக்ட் ஆயிருக்கு இந்த எண்ட் இது கூட கனெக்ட் ஆயிருக்கு இட் will be connected in parallel ஓகேவா சோ அதுக்கு அடுத்து பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா இதுல ஒரே ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் மட்டும் தான் வரும் சோ அதுவும் இதுவும் வந்து என்னது சீரிஸா இருக்கும் நமக்கு கனெக்ஷன் ஓகேவா சோ இது ரெண்டும் வந்து பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா சீரிஸ் சோ இது ரெண்டும் வந்து பாரலலா இருக்குது சோ இது ரெண்டும் பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா நமக்கு வந்து சீரிஸா வரும் பிளஸ் பண்ணிக்கோங்க ஓகேவா சோ அதுக்கு அடுத்து பாத்தீங்கன்னா இங்க ஒரே ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் மட்டும் தான் வந்திருக்கும் சோ இதெல்லாம் நம்ம முடிச்சதுக்கு அப்புறம் ஒரே ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் இருக்கும் இதுல எதுவுமே இல்லாம டைரக்டா கனெக்ஷன் இருக்கிற மாதிரி அஸ்யூம் பண்ணிக்கோங்க சோ இது எல்லாமே முடிச்சதுக்கு அப்புறம் ஒரே ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் மட்டும் தான் நமக்கு வந்து இதெல்லாம் முடிஞ்சதுக்கு அப்புறம் கனெக்ஷன்ல இருக்கும் ஓகேவா சோ அதுக்கு என்ன வேல்யூ வருதுன்னு செக் பண்ணனும் சோ அப்போ பாத்தீங்கன்னா இதுதான் கனெக்ஷன் ரிமைனிங் இருக்கு பாத்தீங்கன்னா இங்க இந்த ஹோலா கம்பைன் ஆகி இதெல்லாம் முடிச்சதுக்கு அப்புறம் ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ இருக்குது அதுக்கு அடுத்து இங்க ஒரு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ இருக்குது இங்க ஒன்னு சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இது ரெண்டையும் முடிங்க ஓகேவா சோ இது ரெண்டும் நமக்கு வந்து சீரிஸ்ல இருக்கு சோ சீரிஸ்ல இருக்கத முடிச்சுக்குவாங்க முடிச்சிட்டீங்கன்னா அதுல வர்ற ஆன்சரை இந்த 20 ஓம்க்கு வந்து பேரலா நமக்கு வந்து கிடைக்கும் சோ அத வந்து யூ ஜஸ்ட் சால்வ் ஹோப் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் திஸ் சோ இந்த ரெசிஸ்டர் ஈக்குவலன்ட் வந்து ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்றது வந்து கண்டிப்பா நமக்கு வந்து எல்லாமே புரிஞ்சிருக்கணும் சோ அதுல இருந்து ஓரளவு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆயிருக்கும்னு நினைக்கிறேன் இந்த மாதிரி சால்வ் பண்ணி பாருங்க 30 ஓம் வந்து நமக்கு வந்து கிடைக்கும் ஓகேவா சோ அதுல ஏதாவது டவுட் இருக்கா Yes, RTH is very much important. Okay, so, a complex circuit is very important. Just they have asked to find out the RTH value. Okay, so, we simplify it. They just want to find out it. So, any doubt in that finding the RTH for that circuit? Any doubt? Okay, no doubt. If you have doubt, means please let me know. So, if you are going on, sorry, sir. Okay, so if it is no doubt, means we just proceed the problem. So that is the thing. Okay, ma'am. So you just follow this method. So first correct ah pandra mari pannite you just proceed the values. Okay va? So once find out the VTH and RTH. Okay, so VTH and RTH find out pannadukku apuram there will not be any RL. Okay va? So adha load resistance edhuvume illa. So we can't be able to find out the load current. Okay, so load resistance avanga kudukama open circuit ada nam kudutha circuit e kudutanga so they will not ask to find out the value of the total current that is load current okay well, load current vandu find out pandradhukku solla matanga so that is enough for this circuit they have asked whether to find out the VTH or RTH okay so this is about the Thevenin's theorem okay so VTH and RTH find out panni so adhula irundhu load current find out panni we can solve like this okay so if you have any doubt means you can ask me regarding the Thevenin's circuits so அதே மாதிரி இந்த சர்க்யூட் வந்து you can solve it yours also so இதல வந்து நோட் தான் யூஸ் பண்ணணும் கிடையாது சரிவா நோட் அனாலிசிஸ் தான் நம்ம யூஸ் பண்ணணும் கிடையாது you can solve it through mesh also சரிவா mesh வச்சு நீங்க இத வந்து சால்வ் பண்ணிரலாம் இதல எந்த ப்ராப்ளமும் கிடையாது சரிவா சோ ஓகே சோ இதல பாத்தீங்கன்னா இத வந்து you can also solve it by mesh also ஓகேவா சோ இதல i1 னு போட்டுக்கலாம் சோ இத i2 னு போட்டுக்கலாம் சோ இத i3 னு போட்டுக்கலாம் you can find out the value of i1 i2 i3 so idula ulla current enna nu kandupidichinga appadina automatically so current flowing vandu kandupidichikalam so node da nama polom abingiradhu vandu avasiyam illa okay va so node analysis na we can simplify the time okay va so time vandu nama vandu simplify pannikalam okay va so otherwise if you not well versed with the node means you just go through this mesh analysis also okay va so i1 i2 i3 so main i3 da namakku vandu theriyum i3 கண்டுபிடிக்கிறதுக்கு வாட் ஆர் ஆல் தி ஈக்குவேஷன்ஸ் வி ஹேவ் அப்படிங்கறது வந்து ஃபைனலா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணிட்டு யூ கேன் ப்ரோசீட் வித் தட் ஆல்சோ ஓகேவா சோ அத வச்சு நம்ம வந்து வோல்டேஜ் அக்ராஸ் 60 ஓம் வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணிக்கலாம் சரியா ஓகே அண்ட் சோ திஸ் இஸ் தி நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் தி நார்டன்ஸ் தியரம் ஓகே சோ நார்டன்ஸ் தியரம் சம்வாட் லைக் தி தெவெனின்ஸ் தியரம் ஆல்சோ ஓகே சோ நார்டன்ஸ் தியரம்க்கு தெவெனின்ஸ் தியரம்க்கு ரொம்ப வந்து டிஃபரன்ஸ் கிடையாது சோ ஒன்லி டிஃபரன்ஸ் இஸ் we are just short circuiting the load ஓகேவா சோ அங்க வந்து என்ன பண்ணுவோம் அப்படினா லோட வந்து we are just making open circuit ஓகேவா லோட we are just removing and make it as an open circuit and from that we just find out the தெவெனின்ஸ் வோல்டேஜ் ஓகேவா சோ here we are going to calculating the Norton's current and Norton's resistance okay well, that is IN RN anga vandu VTH IPH find out pannom RTH find out pannom here we are going to calculate the IN RN okay so for this the simple only change is we are just short circuiting the load resistance anga vandu we are just removing the or open circuiting the load resistance here just we are short circuiting the load resistance okay so that is the only difference and we are going to calculating the current flowing in that okay so current vandu enna flow aagudengradhu vandu calculate pandradha vandu enadhu IN okay so that is one thing and next one for finding RN Norton's resistance whatever the procedure we just follow in the RTH the same thing will be followed for RN also ஓகேவா RTH க்கு என்ன ப்ரோசிஜரோ அதே ப்ரோசிஜர் தான் RN சோ அதனால அந்த ப்ராப்ளம் கிடையாது ஒன்லி டிஃபரன்ஸ் பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா we are going calculating the Norton's current by short circuiting the load resistance okay so that is the term we can able to identify from the IN and or IN sorry IN into RN okay so finally we can also find out the load current by means of the current division rule okay so current division formula vachi we can also find out the load current for this circuit also eva so the same procedure only so for rn there will not be any change in the procedure the same procedure for the rth and rn in case of Norton current we are just short circuiting the load okay va terminal ab ingrada vandu load vandu nama vandu short circuit pannikidrom and we just find out the what is the current flowing through it flowing through it that okay so that is the only thing we are going to find out and the remaining things are same in this eva so hope it is understand we just move into the problem okay so find the Norton equivalent for this given circuit okay so we know that this is the given circuit first of all they have mentioned the terminal ab okay so ab nu or terminal kuduttaanga so there will not be any problem in that we don't want to remove or we don't want to short circuit any of the resistors okay va terminal kudutanaala we just want to short that terminal only so anga vandha enna na terminal kudutanga ab terminal kudutanga appadina adu appadiye open circuit ah we have assumed like that okay va appadiye vach maintain panirpom here ab is a already it is given as an open circuit we are just shorting this ab terminal okay by shorting this ab terminal so from this we can able to find out what is the current flowing in this okay that is the IN we can able to calculate okay so this is the rearranged circuit Okay, so for calculating the Norton's current, okay, so otherwise ISC, that is the short circuit current. Okay, what? So the remaining things all are same. We are just short circuiting the AB terminal. Okay, what? So from this, we just want to calculating the what is the current which will be flowing. Okay, so for this mainly we are using the KCL only. Okay, so we know that if you are calculating the current which will be flowing, we can able to use the node mesh, node analysis, and from this we can calculate the current flowing through this. Okay, so another important point we need to consider. Okay, so if a resistor which will be connected, parallel to this, parallel to a short circuit. If our resistor vandu or short circuit ku parallel la irundichina, the resistor will also act as a short circuit. Okay, so that is one of the important point, please note it down. If a resistor which will be connected parallel to a short circuit means the resistor will also act as a short circuit. Okay, va? So adha mattum epovume vandu mind la vechukonga. So resistor vandu short circuit ah dhaan irukum. So for this circuit there will not be any resistor will be present in this 12 ohm. Okay, va? So you know short circuit ah dhaan act aagum. Okay, va? So adhanaala vandu indha branch vandu we can take it as a short circuit one. Okay, so here we are going to calculating the current. So we are just applying the node analysis. We are just taking a point A, that is node A. Okay, so ground, we are, this is the ground terminal. So what is the voltages which will be present in this node appingiradha vandu we are going to calculate. Okay, va? So for this we are just assuming the values. Okay, so that is the A point la vandu enna la irukkuna assume panna porom. So already A point vandu it is short circuited only, it will be available as a short circuited. So the node value is also having the value as zero. Okay, va? So voltage value vandu adha vandu namakku vandu zero condition la da namakku vandu irukum, because it is the act as a short circuit for all the thing. Okay, va? So adanal enna pandrom, so 0 minus 24. Okay, so 0 minus 24, that is the voltage present in the source. Okay, va? So 0 minus 24 divided by the resistor value 4 which will be present here. Okay, so that is one of the one term. Okay, so this containing this branch, the branch concentrate panumbodhu we can able to get the value like this. So 0 minus 24 divided by 4. So while considering this branch, okay, so that is the current flowing branch. Okay, va? That will be flowing from negative to positive. So this is the ground value or negative value you can able to see. So it will be flowing from negative to positive. So for after equal to we need to mention it as plus value. Okay, va? So it is presenting in before the equivalent value, so it is representing as -3. Okay, equal to epome other side vandu nama vandu plus n mention pannuvom. Okay, va? And we are going to calculating the ISC, that is the short circuit current. Okay, so already we discussed about this, it is also act as a short circuit, so it is mentioning as ISC. It will be flowing from positive to negative. Okay, va? So equal to on the side pogum bodhu it is minus SC nu vandirukom. So equal to indha side irukanaala plus SC nu nama vandu mention pannirukom. Okay, va? So from this we can able to calculate at the ISC, that is the Norton current. Okay, va? So idhula edha doubt iruka? So whenever we are calculating the Norton's current, we probably moving into the node analysis only. Okay, va? So node analysis vachidha vandu we can able to calculating the Norton current. Okay, va? So idha epome just keep it in mind. So whenever a resistor which will be connected parallel to a short circuit, the resistor will also act as a short circuit. Okay, va? So epome vandu you just keep it in mind. Okay, va? So this how we can able to calculate the Norton current. Okay, va? So next we are going to calculate the not on resistance. That is simple thing. So already we have seen the things, the same thing only. Okay, so we just want to short circuit the voltage and open circuit the current. Okay, so the current avandu open circuit panikirom. So terminal epovume open la da irukum. Okay va, so anga vandu short circuit panna vendi avasiyam kedaadu. The terminal will be open circuit. So appo inda terminal mattum varadhu, the current branch mattum we can neglect, and it is a short circuit. So we are having 4 and 12 only, 4 resistor and 12 resistor, which will be connected in parallel. Okay va, so this is the question we can able to give. Okay, source resistance and the current, so sorry, source voltage short circuit panitom, adhe mari current source vandu remove panitom. So remaining vandu we are having only 4 ohm and 12 ohm. It will be connected in parallel, and from that we can calculate at the short on resistance. Okay, so it will be connected in parallel, so 4 into 12 divided by 4 plus 12, from that Rn will be calculated. Okay, so next we need to calculate at the load current. Okay, so load current vandu find out pananum. So we know the equivalent circuit, so we need to connect the current Rn, Rn as well as the In as well as the Rn, which will be connected in parallel. Okay, so we know that whenever the current and resistor which will be mentioning, okay, so current to resistor um mention pannu appadina, it must be mentioned in parallel. Okay, we just saw in the source conversion, so voltage to current source conversion la nama paathom, voltage source um resistor um it should be connected in parallel. Okay, so once we are converting voltage source into current source, means the current as well as the resistor which will be connected in parallel, நம்ம வந்து மாத்தி நம்ம வரையது வந்து நம்ம பாத்துறோம். ஓகேவா, so the same thing will be continuing like here also. Okay, so In as well as the Rn which will be connected in parallel, and this is the equivalent circuit for this. ஓகேவா, load resistance இல்லாதனால we can't able to find out the load current. Okay, well, load current vandu find out panna mudiyadhu. If it is load current they have already mentioned in the circuit, means we can calculate at the load current. Okay, well, so this is about one model, and this is the second problem. So find the Norton equivalent circuit to the left of terminal AB for the network shown below. Connect the Norton equivalent circuit to the load. Connect the Norton equivalent circuit to the load and find the current in the 50 ohm. Okay, so they have asked to calculate the load current which will be flowing through the 50 ohm. So adhey vandu calculate pandradhukku they have mentioned. Okay, so in this circuit we can see that the voltage source is also present as well as a current source is also present. Okay, so once we need to find out the value of the Norton resistance. Okay, well, Norton resistance find out pandradhukku we just want to short circuit the terminal AB. Okay, well, load circuit our load resistance vandu remove panniittu we just want to short circuit A and B. Okay, well, so A and B vandu short circuit panniittu what is the current flowing condition, that is the Norton current appingiradhu vandu find out pannum. Seriya, so this how we can able to short circuit the values. Okay, so load resistance remove panniti we just short circuit at this, and from this we need to find out the Norton current. Okay, so idha pathinga appadina we can solve it by mesh. Okay, so we need to find out the current flowing in this block. Okay, current flowing in this block la mattum enna den nama vandu find out pannita easily we can solve this. Okay, so adhe mari pathinga appadina idhiliye nama vandu enna current flow aagudhu, so from this mesh in the mesh la vandu automatically we can able to see this. Okay, so id I1 id I2 I3 nu eduthinga appadina, so I3 current is already we know that is 10 ampere. Okay, so only current which will be flowing in this branch. Okay, in the mesh la vandu in the branch la mattum dhaan flow aagudhu. So I3 ni eduthikittinga I3 value yerkume namakku vandu theriyum, so adha calculate panikalam. So adhe mari I2 ye nama vandu calculate panna, that is the Norton resistance. Okay va, so mesh 1 la vandu enna equation varum find out pannunga, அடுத்து மெஷ் 2ல வந்து என்ன ஈக்குவேஷன் தட் இஸ் மெஷ் 2 மீன்ஸ் திஸ் இஸ் 1 அண்ட் மெஷ் 3 நமக்கு ஏற்கனவே தெரியும் 10 ஓம் சாரி 10 ஆம்பியர்னு தெரியும் ஃப்ரம் திஸ் வி கேன் கால்குலேட் தி I2 வேல்யூ ஓகேவா சோ மெஷ் நமக்கு ஞாபகம் இருக்கும்னு நினைக்கிறேன் சோ ஒன்ஸ் வி ஆர் கால்குலேட்டிங் தி கரண்ட் ஃப்ளோயிங் த்ரூ திஸ் மெஷ் இந்த மெஷ்ல பண்ணோம் அப்படினா சோ வாட் எவர் தி ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் பிரசன்ட் இன் தி மெஷ் ஓகேவா சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆட் தட் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் வேல்யூ So 20 plus 60, that is 80 I1. Okay, so that is the first one. And 60 will be present to both the mesh. Give a common to both the mesh. So that is minus 60 I2. And 20 will be present common to I3 as well as I1. Okay, so that is minus 20 I3 equal to the current will be flowing in minus 2 positive. That is will be in the same direction equal to 50. Okay, so likewise, I3 means there will not be no need to find out the equation. Already we know that I3 is equal to 10 ampere. Okay, wow. So ore or block of matana in the branch of matana kudutukanaala, it is only specifically for I3. Okay, wow. Or direct I3 equal to 10 nu eludhikalam. Okay, wow. While considering this mesh 2, okay, wow. So idha consider pannumbodhu 60 is common for I1 and I2. That is first one minus 60 I1. Okay. So they have changed the sign, nothing in that. Okay, minus 60 I1 and O1, so they will present it as plus. Okay, wow. So again, inside la, if you are considering I2, so 60 plus 40, 100 I2 and O1. For this, they have mentioned this sign minus. Okay, so all sign change for you now. All of them. So 40 is common to I3 and I2. Okay, I3 ko I2 ko common are given. So minus 40 I3 and O1, plus 40 I3 and O1. Equal to O1. எதுமே இல்ல அதனால வந்து சைன் வந்து ஃபுல்லா சேஞ்ச் பண்ணிருக்காங்க அவ்வளவுதான் வேற ஒண்ணு கிடையாது ஓகே சோ from this we know the value of I3 value so just substitute the I3 values and from this just find out the value of I2 ஓகேவா I2 மட்டும் தான் நமக்கு தேவை ஏனா இந்த டெர்மினல்ல ஃப்ளோ ஆற கரண்ட் தான் நமக்கு தேவை சோ ஒன்ஸ் யூ ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் I2 இட் இஸ் தி நார்டன் கரண்ட் ஓகே சோ இஃப் தேர் இஸ் எனி டவுட் ரிகார்டிங் திஸ் சர்க்யூட் find out the value of IN ye nama yatne mesh la paathadhu da so idha doubts irundhuchna you can ask for calculating IN so whatever the circuit you can solve it by mesh or node edha vena neenga use pannikalam so what is comfortable for you okay so ungalku edhu comfortable ah irukko you can use that So any doubt in this calculating IN? இல்ல இருக்கீங்க இல்ல Any doubt? Okay. No. Okay. So, if it is clear, you just calculated the RN. Okay. You just calculated the RN for this circuit. Okay. So, if you are clear, means. Okay, so find out the value of RN. RN, you need to calculate. Pretty simple, Babu. You just want to remove this resistor. Okay, in the resistor, remove. Pani to open a vajde. Just find out the value of RN. Short circuit at the voltage and open circuit at the current, and just find out the RN. once you find, just tell me the answer. Make it quick.
Sir, 55.
55. The concept is we are just short circuit this and we are just eliminate the current and there will not be any 50 ohm, it is open. Remaining thing is this 3 only. Okay. So 20 and 60 which will be connected in parallel. So 20 parallel 60 plus 40 it will be connected in series. So that is the concept. Okay. Like that means that is 55. Okay, so that is the answer. Okay, so this is the arrangement. We just short circuited the voltage source and open circuited the current. So remaining thing is this is the thing. Okay, so 20 and 60 which will be connected in parallel and 40 which will be connected in series for this thing. Okay, and from this we need to hope it is understand. So everyone understand regarding this. So if you have any doubts you can ask. Okay, so we know that IN and RN. Okay, so IN is 10.7 ampere and RN is 55 ohm. So we know the load resistor as 50 ohm. Okay, so from this we need to calculate the load current. So we need to find out the load current. So in the 50 ohm la flow ara current enadhu IL vandu find out padanum. So adu eppadi kandupidikalam? Enna use pannalam?
Current division rule.
Yeah, okay, super. So that is current division rule, we need to substitute. So find out the value. So current division ku vandu namakku vandu enadhu, so idu vandu R2 nu RL nu vechukonga. Okay, load resistance RL, idu vandu R1 nu vechukonga. Okay va, appo IL is equal to I into, this is the total current I into opposite resistance, that is 55 divided by total resistance 50 plus 55. Okay, so this is the formula for this is the thing. Okay, so idha namakku theriyum. So IL is equal to IN, that is the Norton current, and RN, this is the 55 opposite resistor, divided by RN plus RL. This is the volt current division formula. Yeah, so just substitute panna, we can able to get the answer. So you can implement all the things in any way. Yeah, so ella edathilum ellame use pandra mari namakku theriyum. Whatever it may be, mesh la nalum seri, nodal la nalum seri, Thevenin's, Norton's, ellathilume vandu we can use any of the formula. The current division, voltage division, any the formula nalum use pandra mari we can able to have a clear idea with this. So just substitution, answer is 5.6. okay, so there is a variation here. So if you have any doubt in this, in this problem, that doubt irundhuchna solunga paapom, ina we are moving to next topic. So Thevenin's as well as Norton's, if you have any doubts, it's already 1 hour. Take it. Okay, so no Mishra. Yeah, some more topics also having. We can rush them something. So before that we just solve this thing. So whatever the problems it will be given for homework to solve yourself. So anyone solve this first problem? What is the value of IT, total current? Solve panningla?
5.2 ampere.
5.2 ampere. Okay. So, எல்லாத்துக்கும் ஆன்சர் வந்திருக்கா? IT. Anyone having any variation in this answer? So just we need to make the equivalent resistor value. Okay, so we need to simplify the circuit. That's the thing. Nothing in that. Okay. Once we simplify and find out the R equivalent, IT is equal to V divided by R equivalent. All along. So for this, we need to know how to simplify the resistance. Okay. So the other one is there. So if we in the side, let me talk about. Okay, so these two things are connected in series. Okay, va. So plus, so this is connected in series. So wherever the parallel connection you are having, okay, wherever the parallel connection you are having, first simplify that thing. Okay, parallel and internal are required. All of them, modelly simplify, pani vayenge. Okay, va. So next, you need to simplify this parallel thing. Okay, so 4-4, it will be parallel. So random me on the same value and this one, I know so you know parallel resistor line. What will be the answer? If the resistor
half of the value.
Half of the value.
Half of that particular value. Okay, va. So 4-4, it will be connected in parallel means just simply place it as 2-0. Okay, so வந்து நீங்க போட்டு பார்க்கணும் அவசியம் கிடையாது என்னதா இருந்தாலும் என்ன இது இருந்தாலும் இன்கேஸ் 16 இருந்துச்சுன்னா ஜஸ்ட் 8-0 ஓகே 30-32 இருந்துச்சுன்னா 16-0 லைக் தட் ஓகே ஸோ நெக்ஸ்ட் பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா 4-0 2-0 ஸோ இது ரெண்டே சிம்பிளிஃபை பண்ண இந்த பேரலல் சிம்பிளிஃபை பண்ணா 2-0 கிடைக்கும் ஸோ இது டோட்டலாக பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 6-0 நமக்கு வந்து இதில் வந்து வந்துடும் ஓகே ஸோ இது ரெண்டும் சீரியஸ் ஆல்ரெடி 4+2 6 ஓகே ஸோ அப்போ 6-6 பேரலல் ஓகே ஸோ இது எல்லாமே நம்ம சிம்பிளிஃபை பண்ணி முடிச்சோம்னா 6 in kadaikum idha simplify pannalum 6 in kadaikum so 6 6 parallel means adha simplify panna enna varum 3 nu varum okay va so adutathu idu rendum vandu parallel irukku so 6 3 okay va 6 3 is 18 divided by 9 na 2 ohm okay va so idhu 2 ohm nu varum so idu rendey simplify panni vachadhula vandu namakku enna varum 3 nu kadachirukum okay va so appo 3 2 it will be connected in series that is 5 ohm okay va so appo total equivalent resistor vandu 5 ohm so adhula irundhu IT value கண்டுபிடிச்சோம் அப்படின்னா 5 ஆம்பியர்னு வரும் ஓகேவா பாயிண்ட்ல வரல ஜெர்ல இதுக்கு வருது இல்லையா வேற சேஞ்சஸ் இருக்கா 18 divided by 9 so it is 2 ohm 4-4-2 4-2-6, 4-2-6, 6-6 parallel 3, 3-5, that is 5. Answer is 5 ampere. Total current is 5 ampere. Okay, va? So this is how we can able to solve this problem. So, remember, solve panirni paniping nadikira. So this is just a simple one. Okay, so next vandu second problem kudutha na aama okay second one we have to solve panninga we are need to calculating the current that is current which will be flowing through 8 ohm 8 ohm la flow ara current vandu find out panom enna panninga first So how can we simplify this circuit? Simplify பண்ணா தான் நம்ம இத வந்து proceed பண்ண முடியும். எப்படி பண்ணலாம்?
Source transformation.
மைண்ட்ல வர வேண்டியது ஓகேவா சோ என்ன எப்படி சிம்பிளிஃபை பண்ணலாம் அப்படிங்கறத வந்து மைண்ட்ல வந்தாதான் வந்து we can proceed the problem ஓகேவா சோ for this we just want to convert the source சோ எப்பவுமே நமக்கு தெரியும் if you want to find out the current means current find out பண்ணனும்னா the circuit must be in the sources of voltages only ஓகேவா சோ கரண்ட் கால்குலேட் பண்ணனும்னா சர்க்யூட் வந்து வோல்டேஜா இருந்தாதான் வந்து we can able to solve the thing ஓகேவா சோ for this we know that இங்க பாத்தீங்கன்னா கரண்ட் as well as the resistor which will be connected in parallel like this here also there is a resistor as well as the current which will be connected in parallel you just convert this thing into voltage source and like that you just convert this thing into voltage source convert panna enna varum so v is equal to I into r so I namakku theriyum r theriyum so 5 into 12 na that is 60 volt okay so 60 volt vandirukku so how we can redraw this structure okay so that is current flowing in this direction okay so epovume vandu negative to positive la flow aagum appo idla podum bodhu this is negative and this is positive that is important how we can able to mention the sign okay va so the sign e eppadi mention pandrom abingiradha vandu romba romba important like that here also we need to calculating the voltage so I into r that is 25 into 30 evlo varum
750
volt 750 varum okay 750 is the voltage okay va so here also you just have the note in the direction okay va so keela irukku mele pod that is negative to positive appo mele vande we need to mention the positive keela vande negative okay so the resistor value we just mentioned here that is 30 ohm so this is already 8 ohm and this is already 12 ohm okay so from this we need to calculate the flow of current so resistor ellame series la irundhuchna enna artham current flowing vandu eppadi irukum series resistance la current flow vandu eppadi irukum
same a irukum
okay va so adanal இத அப்படியே நீங்க வந்து சிம்பிளிஃபை பண்ணிக்கலாம் 12 plus 8 20 20 plus 30 50 அப்போ 50 ஓம் ரெசிஸ்டர் ஓகேவா அப்போ இந்த ஃப்ளோ வர கரண்ட் வந்து எப்பவுமே இந்த டைரக்ஷன்ல எடுங்க ஏன்னா அவங்க டைரக்ஷன் கொடுத்துட்டாங்க ஓகேவா எப்பவுமே நம்ம கிளாக் வைஸ்ல தான் எடுப்போம் ஆனா தே ஹேவ் மென்ஷன் தி டைரக்ஷன் as the anti clockwise கொடுத்தனால யூ ஜஸ்ட் டேக் இட் இன் ரிவர்ஸ் டைரக்ஷன் ஓகேவா anti clockwiseல எடுத்துட்டு சோ இது வந்து 60 ஓம் and this one is 750 okay so from this you can easily find out the value of current okay va so totala vandu 50 ohm irukum so idla vandu flow aagudhu vandu negative to positive same direction a irukanaala equal to kanda side 16 potukalam so inda side pathinga appadina negative to positive da same direction so you can also mention as plus 750 so 60 plus 750 equal to 50 I okay va so adula irundhu I value endadhu abingiradha vandu calculate pannanum okay va so first thing is we need to identify how to solve this okay va so adha eppadi simplify panni solve pannalam abingiradha vandu just we need to find out adha find out pannitinga remaining steps is very easy remaining vandu just calculation you can definitely easily finish it okay so adanal ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டெப் எப்படி அதை சிம்பிளிஃபை பண்ணலாம் அப்படிங்கிற ஐடியா மட்டும் நமக்கு வந்துச்சுன்னா தட் இஸ் எரர் ஓகேவா அண்ட் ஸோ தேர்ட் ஒன் ஸோ இது சிம்பிளாக சொல்லிடலாம் நினைக்க நீங்களே டக்குன்னு சொல்லுங்க பார்ப்போம் இதை சால்வ் பண்ணணும் அவசியம் கிடையாது ஓகே ஸோ 6 ஆம்பியர் ஸோ வாட் இஸ் தி ப்ரொசீஜர் டு சால்வ் திஸ்
லாஸ்ட்ல இருக்கிற டூ ரெசிஸ்டர்ஸ் வந்து பேரலலா இருக்கு 6 ohm and 12 ohm. So அது solve பண்ணா 4 ohm கிடைக்கும். அடுத்து 4 ohm 12 ohm parallel ஆ இருக்கும். அது solve பண்ணா 3 ohm கிடைக்கும். 7 ohm 3 ohm series ஆ இருக்கும். அது add பண்ணா 10 ohm.
ஓகே சூப்பர். சோ தட் இஸ் தி ஆன்சர். சோ இதுல என்ன பாத்தீங்கன்னா நம்ம சர்க்யூட்ட வந்து குழப்பற மாதிரியே கொடுத்துருப்பாங்க. சோ i2 i3 i4 எல்லாம் நமக்கு தேவையே கிடையாது. ஓகேவா? சோ தே வில் ஆஸ்க் only to calculate the current i. அப்ப நமக்கு i மட்டும் தான் தேவை. சோ இந்த i1 i2 i3 i4 பத்தி நமக்கு கண்டுக்க வேண்டிய அவசியமே கிடையாது. ஓகேவா? சோ நம்ம குழப்பணும்ங்கிறதுக்காக அதே மாதிரி கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. ஓகேவா? சோ ஜஸ்ட் சிம்பிளிஃபை. சோ தி ஈக்குவலன்ட் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் எல்லாமே வந்து ஈக்குவலன்ட் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸா கன்வெர்ட் பண்ணிட்டீங்கன்னா யூ கேன் ஏபிள் டு கால்குலேட் தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் i. அவ்வளவுதான். ஓகேவா? சோ அதுக்கு என்ன பண்ணுங்க? சோ இந்த மாதிரி இருந்துச்சுன்னா you no need to take this thing first id rendu edukkanum ena id rendu namakku vandha enadhu common ah irukku okay va so adala enna pannunga first this one and this one okay 12 12 na answer enadhu 6 parallel irundhuchna appadi divide aavum yerkane oru 6 irukku appo 6 6 na that will be 3 okay va so appo total ah indha circuit e vandu 3 nu namakku kadaikrom yerkane 7 irukum appo total vandu 10 ohm okay va so adula irundhu voltage or current வந்து ஈஸியா கண்டுபிடிச்சுக்கலாம் so i is equal to v by r 60 divided by 10 answer is 6 அவ்வளவுதான் ஓகேவா so எப்பவுமே parallel resistors if you are they are mentioned means you just see whether any same data is available okay so இதல 12 6 பண்ணீங்கன்னா கொஞ்சம் டைம் வந்து நமக்கு எடுக்கும் ஓகேவா so இது ரெண்டும் சேமா இருக்கனால வந்து first simplify this so ரெண்டும் சேமா இருக்கனால 12 divided by 2 னா 6 னு நமக்கு தெரியும் ஏற்கனவே 6 6 ரெண்டுமே அப்புறம் வரும் 6 divided by 2 nu potona 3 so 7 plus 3 answer is 10 ohm so adil irundhu i value vandu calculate panikkom seriya and next one star 2 delta va so they have asked to find out the equivalent circuit equivalent terminal resistor value of a and d a ku d ku illa equivalent resistance values வந்து calculate பண்ண சொல்றாங்க சோ எப்படி பண்ணலாம் AD தான் நமக்கு தேவை ஃபைனலா வந்து we just want to have the terminal AD அது ரெண்டும் வந்து சிம்பிளிஃபை ஆகாம நம்ம பாத்துக்கணும் remaining whatever the terminal it can able to remove சோ ஏதாவது if you have any solutions to remove means you can able to remove the things but we must want to keep the point AD given so that is the main thing we need to consider how we can able to solve so this is available in delta both things a b c likewise b c d it will be available in delta format enna pannalam first step Any idea? Okay. So I just tell the hints. So first, you just consider this delta tab. Okay, so BCD delta term over there, you just converted into star. Okay, so A value of DNA is going, B value of DNA is going to star and convert. Okay, so we have to do the term of DNA. Okay, so we have to do this is point A. And this is point C and this is point B. Okay, so in the delta va irundhathu vandu we are just converted into star. Okay, so this is the conversion rate and this is the terminal D. So this is RD and this is RB and this is RC. we just want to calculate the values by using that formula. Okay, this is the 4 ohm, this is the 2 ohm already they have mentioned in the problem. Okay, va? So we know that if the values are same in delta, delta la if the values are same means in star, what the operation will happen? என்ன சொன்னீங்க multiply by 3. Okay, so in case of star to delta abinna
divide by 3.
Okay, divide by 3. Okay, so abiye correct ah maathi solitinga, super. So enna abinna idha mattum nyavachukonga, abiye maathi solitinga vera onnum kedaiya, seriya? So delta da it will be having the highest value. டெல்டால தான் எப்பவுமே அதிகமான வேல்யூ இருக்கும் ஸ்டார விட அப்படின்னு ஞாபகம் ஓகேவா. சோ ஸ்டார் இஸ் ஹேவிங் தி லோவஸ்ட் வேல்யூ, டெல்டா இஸ் ஹேவிங் தி ஹையஸ்ட் வேல்யூ அப்படின்னு ஞாபகம் ஓகேவா. சோ அப்ப என்ன அப்படின்னா இஃப் யூ ஆர் கன்வெர்ட்டிங் டெல்டா இன்டு ஸ்டார் மீன்ஸ் வி ஜஸ்ட் வாண்ட் டு இஃப் தி வேல்யூஸ் ஆர் சேம், இந்த மூணு வேல்யூஸ் சேமா இருந்துச்சு அப்படின்னா யூ ஜஸ்ட் டிவைட் இட் பை 3 ஓகேவா. சோ அவ்வளவுதான் ப்ரொசீஜர். அப்ப பாத்தீங்கன்னா சோ எல்லாமே 3 3 3 ஓகேவா. So just we are having the 1 ohm. So RB to 1 ohm, RB to 1 ohm, RC to 1 ohm. Okay, va? So adha mattum konjam niyamichukonga. Okay, va? So conversion la vandu, if the values is same, okay, va? So idhula paadha, idhula vandu paathale ungalukku theriyum. Star la vandu delta ku pogumbodhu, star la vandu 111 nu irukku, delta la vandu 333 nu irukku. So eppovume delta ku dhaan value vandu, it will be high. Okay. அதே மாதிரி ஸ்டாருக்கு வேல்யூ வந்து இட் வில் பி ஹேவிங் லோ ஓகேவா. சோ அதை ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கோங்க. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் தி கன்வர்ஷன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டெப் வி கேன் மேக் ஓகே. ஸோ அடுத்தது பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா வி வாண்ட் டு மெயின்டைன் தி பாயிண்ட் ஏடி, ஏடியை மட்டும் அப்படியே வந்து மெயின்டைன் பண்ணியிருக்கணும் ஓகேவா. ஸோ ரிமைனிங் திங்ஸ் பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா யூ கேன் சிம்பிளிஃபை. ஸோ 4 ஓம் அண்ட் 1 ஓம் இட் வில் பி கனெக்டட் இன் எதில் இருக்கு, எப்படி இருக்கு 4 ohm, 1 ohm, whether it is connected in parallel or series. The 4 ohm, the 1 ohm, parallel or series. First step after converting this delta into star. Okay, so after that you just simplify this value 4 ohm and 1 ohm which will be connected in series like that, these two term which will be connected in series. Okay, va? Suppose we can have the simplified diagram like this. Okay, so here we are having the value 5 and 2 plus 1, here we are having the value 3 and here we are having the value 1. Okay, so after that you can simplify this also. This will be connected in parallel. So 5 into 3 divided by 8. what will be the answer? We just write it down and add it by what? Okay. So, the answer is 15 divided by 8, 9 hours.
One point eight, sir.
Okay. So, our total answer is
2.875.
Okay, super. Guys. That is 2.8 ohm is the resistor value between point A and B. Okay. So like this, we just want to simplify the terms. Okay, so I know like either in the resistor code value better come low, we just want to maintain that point. Okay, we just don't want to neglect that point. We just maintain that point still, and remaining blocks we just want to simplify it. Okay, so that's the thing we need to keep it in mind. Okay, so just if you are having any circuits or any blocks which will be given means, you just see it for 1 minute. Okay, so just be a part there, that way you can able to get ideas. Okay, so that way, for the second day, when you are doing a good you can able to get ideas. So how to initialize the process? Yeah, that is the very important. So if we start pondering, either which start pondering is important. So start panic on Vina, just definitely we can able to get the answer. So for that, you just need to give some time to observe the circuits. Okay, so on one what method we can able to solve this problem. So we just finish this problem and move into next topic and we keep later. Okay, so how you can able to solve this? Determine power delivered by the current source. Okay, answer is 1.28 watt. Okay, so this is the answer, final answer. Okay, so first what we need to do, so I'm gonna just read the problem. Determine power delivered by the current source. Okay, so source and kurtale epome vandu enadhu, this one is the source. Okay, so these are all the power delivered inga flow indha flow aradhu idhula flow aradhu idhula flow aradhu ellame vandu delivered power. Okay, so source na namak irukku ellame therinjadhu. Okay, so source abingiradhu vandu that is the it can able to having the powers. Okay, so current or voltage adhula irundha vandu namak vandu power e vandu velila pogum. Okay, so that is the source. Appo இதுல வந்து எவ்வளவுக்கு பவர் வந்து டெலிவர் ஆகும் கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ்ல இருந்து அப்படிங்கறது வந்து தே ஆர் ஆஸ்கிங் தி க்வெஸ்சன். ஓகே, ஃபார் திஸ் வி டோன்ட் நோ தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் ஐ. ஐ வேல்யூ வந்து நமக்கு வந்து என்னது தெரியாது. ஃபார் திஸ் வி ஜஸ்ட் வாண்ட் டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் ஐ. ஓகேவா, ஐ வேல்யூ வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணாதான் வந்து வி கேன் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் தி பவர் டெலிவர். சோ எப்படி ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணலாம்?
சார், 4 ஆம்பியர் கரண்ட் ஃப்ளோ ஆகுதுல, அப்போ அதுவும் அதுவும் ஈக்குவலா தானே இருக்கும்?
4 ஆம்பியர் கரண்ட் ஈக்குவலா இருக்கும்னு சொல்றீங்களா? சோர்ஸுக்கும் ஈக்குவலா இருக்கும்னு சொல்றீங்களா? சோ இதுல இருந்து சோர்ஸ் நமக்கு வருது அப்படின்னா சீரிஸ்ல நமக்கு சேமா வரும் சோ வைல் இட் கம்மிங் இன்டு தி பேரலல் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் வரும்போது இட் கெட் டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட்டட் அப்படிதானே இதுல கொஞ்சம் கரண்ட் ஃப்ளோ ஆகும் இது ரெண்டையும் ஆட் பண்ணா என்ன கரண்டோ அதுதான் வந்து சோர்ஸ் கரண்ட் ஓகேவா அப்போ ஒரு இதுல வந்து ஃப்ளோ ஆகிற கரண்ட் வேல்யூ நமக்கு தெரிஞ்சிருச்சு ஆல்ரெடி வி ஜஸ்ட் வாண்ட் டு நோ திஸ் கரண்ட் இது தெரிஞ்சாதான் ஒண்ணு டோட்டல் கரண்ட் என்னதுன்னு வந்து நமக்கு வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ண முடியும் ஓகேவா அப்படின்னா நம்ம வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பார்க்கணும் So, again, the formula use for line, I use for line. So, we are knowing one current value. Okay, one resistor order current value there is C. So, other than the total current one, we find out for now. Now, tell me, Vijay.
சார் அந்த 4 ஓம் 2 ஓம் வந்து பேரலல்ல இருக்கு ஸோ நம்ம அதோட எஃபெக்டிவ் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஃபைண்ட் பண்ணிட்டு அதில் அந்த ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸையும் இந்த கரண்ட்டையும் மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணால் வோல்ட் கிடைக்கும் ஸோ அந்த வோல்ட் தான் இந்த கரண்ட் ஐக்கு பேரலாக இருக்கும் ஸோ அந்த வோல்ட் டிவைடட் பை 5 ஓம் போட்டால் அந்த ஐ கிடைச்சிடும் சார் சார் அதான் நமக்கு இங்கே வோல்டேஜ் தெரிஞ்சிடலாம் சார் 4 ஆம்பியர் கரண்ட் தென் இந்த 4 ஓம் 2 ஓம் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸில் எவ்வளோ போகுதுன்னு நம்ம அந்த வோல்டேஜ் ஃபைண்ட் பண்ணிவிட்டு அதுக்கப்புறம் அந்த 5 ஓம் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸால் டிவைட் பண்ணால் அந்த லூப்பில் போகிற கரண்ட் கிடச்சிடும்ல சார்
ஓகே ஸோ அது ஒரு மெத்தட் சொல்கிறீங்க ஆனால் அந்த மெத்தடில் வராது நான் என்ன அப்படின்னா நமக்கு தெரிஞ்ச ஒரே ஒரு கரண்ட் வந்து என்ன அப்படின்னா டேக் இட் அஸ் I1 ஆர் I2 இதில் வந்து I2ன்னு எடுத்துக்கோங்க சரியா டோட்டல் கரண்ட் கிடையாது இது ஸோ இதுலேயும் ஒரு கரண்ட் வந்து நமக்கு வந்து எனக்கு ஃப்ளோ ஆகும் ஸோ இதை வந்து I1 எடுத்துக்கோங்க டோட்டல் கரண்ட் IE ஸோ இந்த கரண்ட் வந்து I1 இந்த கரண்ட் வந்து I2 ஸோ இதை சிம்பிளிஃபை பண்ணி நம்ம எடுத்தோம்னா ஈக்குவலன்ட் ரெசிஸ்டர் கண்டுபிடிச்சிடலாம் ஆனால் டோட்டல் கரண்ட் வந்து நமக்கு கிடைக்காது இதில் வந்து I1 கரண்ட் மட்டும்தான் நமக்கு தெரியும் I2 கரண்ட் மட்டும்தான் நமக்கு தெரியும் I1 கரண்ட் வந்து நமக்கு தெரியாது அப்போ ஒரு பிரான்ச்ல வர்ற கரண்ட்டை மட்டும் வச்சுட்டு நம்ம வந்து வோல்டேஜ் கண்டுபிடிக்க முடியாது கரெக்ட் தானே இது அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆகுதா
எஸ் சார்
இது ஒரே ஒரு ஃபார்முலா தான் என்ன ஃபார்முலா
கரண்ட் டிவிஷன் ரூல்
கரண்ட் டிவிஷன் அவ்வளோதான் முடிஞ்சு போச்சு இந்த ஒரு ஃபார்முலா தான் அது மட்டும்தான் நமக்கு ஞாபகம் வந்துச்சுன்னா மேட்ரே முடிஞ்சு ஸோ அப்போ கரண்ட் டிவிஷன் அப்படின்னா ஃபார்முலா என்ன அப்படின்னா வி நோ தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் I2 வேல்யூ நமக்கு தெரியும் ஓகேவா ஸோ ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ எல்லாமே நமக்கு தெரியும் அப்போ என்னன்னா யூ ஜஸ்ட் யூஸ் தி கரண்ட் டிவிஷன் ஃபார்முலா ஃபார் I2 அப்போ ஈக்குவேஷன் என்னன்னு பார்த்தீங்க கரண்ட் ஈக்குவேஷன் என்னன்னு பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா I2 is equal to I into four ohm opposite resistor. Okay, well, opposite resistor divided by total resistor 4+2. Okay, well, so idhula vandu I2 value namakku theriyum. That is 4 ampere. அப்போ 4 ஈக்குவல் டு திஸ் 1 ஸோ இதுல இருந்து ஐ வேல்யூ வந்து ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கா ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணிடலாமா புரியுதா ஸோ நமக்கு வந்து ரெசிஸ்டர் வந்து என்னது டிவை பேரலா இருந்துச்சுன்னா கரண்ட் கெட் டிவைட்ஸ் ஓகேவா அப்போ I2 மட்டும் நமக்கு தெரியும் I1 தெரியாது ஸோ I2 ஃபார்மா என்னது I2 இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு I into ஆப்போசிட் ரெசிஸ்டர் 4 டிவைடட் பை 4+2 ஸோ இதில் I2 வேல்யூ தெரியும் ஆப்போசிட் ரெசிஸ்டர் தெரியும் டோட்டல் ரெசிஸ்டர் தெரியும் இந்த ரெண்டு பேரலாம் இருக்க ரெசிஸ்டர் தெரியும் ஓகேவா ஸோ அதுல இருந்து I வேல்யூ கண்டுபிடிச்சிடலாமா அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆகுதா ஓகேவா ஸோ இதில் வந்து பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா ஸோ இந்த 4 இந்த 4 கேன்சல் ஆயிரும் ஸோ I இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு என்ன வரும் 6 வரும் புரியுதா? That is the total current. So current source value வந்து என்னன்னு வரும், 6 நமக்கு வந்து கிடைக்கும். So இதுல இருந்து we need to find out the value of power. Okay, so power is equal to voltage namak theriyadu, so we are using the current equation. Current equation, so I square into R equivalent. Okay, so R equivalent enna varudhu abingiradhu vandu you just find out. So 4 into 2 divided by 4 plus 2 plus 5 ohm. Enna answer varudha, that is the R equivalent. I value vandu 6 nu theriyum, so 6 square into R equivalent potona that is the power value we can able to get. Yeah, understand aagudha? So adha konjam idu mattum dhaan namakku theriyum. Okay va, so the problem namakku solve panna dhaan you can get this idea. இல்ல யாருக்காவது எதுவும் டவுட் இருக்கா? விஷார்னி 228 வாட். ஓகே, சோ இத சால்வ் பண்ணீங்கன்னா என்ன ஆன்சரோ அதுதான் ஆன்சர். 36 into equivalent resistor என்ன வேல்யூ வந்துச்சோ அது 228 வந்துச்சுன்னா 228. So this is the method. Okay, so how we can solve this? The answer கண்டுபிடிக்கலாம். This is ETH, R and RTH. Okay, so let's move to next topic. Okay, so that is what we are having, some more topics also. Next one, superposition theorem. So hope everyone know about the superposition theorem. Okay, so superposition theorem means the current through or voltage across any element of network is equal to the algebraic sum of the current or voltage produced independently by each source. Okay, so it is nothing but if you are having any circuit having the voltage source or current source or you know whatever the things, if you are having two voltage sources or if you are having two current sources like that. If you are having like that means we just want to assume only one source at a time. Okay, well, like circuit எடுத்துக்கிட்டீங்க அப்படின்னா ஒரு ரெண்டு வோல்டேஜ் சோர்ஸ் இருக்குது அப்படின்னா யூ ஜஸ்ட் அஸ்யூம் எனி ஒன் ஆஃப் தி வோல்டேஜ் சோர்ஸ் அட் அ டைம். ஓகேவா, ஸோ இன்னொரு வோல்டேஜ் சோர்ஸ் வந்து யூ ஜஸ்ட் ஷார்ட் சர்க்யூட் தட். ஓகேவா, ஸோ வோல்டேஜ்னால நமக்கு எப்பவுமே எப்படி என்ன பண்ணுவோம், ஷார்ட் சர்க்யூட் தான் பண்ணுவோம், கரண்ட்னா ஓப்பன் சர்க்யூட் பண்ணுவோம். ஓகேவா, ஸோ வி ஜஸ்ட் கால்குலேட்டிங் தி வேல்யூஸ் வோல்டேஜ் from through the one voltage source. Okay, va or voltage source vachi namakku vandu enna value kadachirukku, next step you just short this voltage and assume that voltage and from that you just calculating the voltage. So rendu add panna total ah ulla voltage source enadhu abingiradhu vandu namakku kadai. Okay, va so just simplifying the thing. Okay, va so or rendu idu irundhuchuna or idu assume panni enna value vandu adutha innoru idu short pannita adutha assume panni enna value vandu அதிரண்டே ஆட் பண்ணா டோட்டலா உள்ள வோல்டேஜ் வேல்யூ வரலாம். திஸ் இஸ் தி திங். லைக்வைஸ் கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ் ஆல்சோ. ஓகேவா, ரெண்டு கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ் இருக்கு அப்படின்னா ஒரு கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ் ஓபன் சர்க்யூட் பண்ணிட்டு ஒரு கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ் அஸ்யூம் பண்ணிட்டு யூ ஜஸ்ட் கால்குலேட் தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் தி வோல்டேஜ் அண்ட் நெக்ஸ்ட் செகண்ட் ஸ்டெப் வந்து இந்த கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ் ஓபன் சர்க்யூட் பண்ணிட்டு அந்த கரண்ட் சோர்ஸ் மட்டும் அஸ்யூம் பண்ணி யூ ஜஸ்ட் கால்குலேட் தி வோல்டேஜ். ஓகேவா, ஸோ அதிரண்டே ஆட் பண்ணா வெதர் யூ கேன் கெட் தி டோட்டல் வோல்டேஜ் அதை கண்டுபிடிக்கிறது தான் வந்து சூப்பர் பொசிஷன் தியரம். ஓகேவா, ஸோ it is just a simple one only. Okay, va, and this is the steps I have just told you. Okay, so enna solrana adha appadi irukum and this is the thing. Okay, so if you are having this is one voltage source and if you are having another voltage source means you just make it short circuit district. You either short circuit panikonga adhe mari rendu current source irundhuchu appadina you just made one current source open circuit and another current source as the thing you just find out the values of both the things independently. Okay va? And so this is the example. Okay, so find the current in the 6 ohm. We just want to find the current in the 6 ohm through using a principle of superposition for a circuit. So this is the circuit. We just want to calculating the current through the 6 ohm and find out the value of the current through the 6 ohm. Okay, so superposition mulema find out panom. So already we said we just want to having only one source. First we are assuming the voltage source and just removing the current source. So current source nale epovume ad open circuit ah da maatuvom. Okay va, open circuit ah maatuvom. So it will be act as a open circuit. Okay, so we just want to find out the value of the current I. Okay va, by using the voltage source. The voltage source ah mattum vachi current enna varudhu calculate pandrom. It is a simple thing. Okay va, equivalent resistor eduthukonga. Eduthittu first find out the value of the I dash. Okay va, by using the voltage source. Phi is equal to 6/9 nu podinga answer I dash vandu value undu namak kadachum. Okay va, so next one we are using the second source, that is the current source. In the current source assume panite you just short circuit the voltage source. Okay va, so idha vandu I double dash nu eduthukonga. Okay va, so I double dash vachittu how we can able to calculate the current. Okay va, so appo idhula irundhu nama vandu calculate பண்ணிக்கலாம் by using the current division formula. Okay va, so I double dash is equal to total current 2 into opposite resistance 3 divided by 3 plus 6. So this is the formula we can able to use this. Okay va, so adhil irundhu I dash கண்டுபிடிச்சிரலாம். So from this I1 plus I dash plus I double dash is equal to what is the value of the current which will be flowing through the resistor அப்படிங்கறது வந்து we can easily find out. Okay va, so இதுல flow ஆற கரண்ட் இந்த ரெண்டையும் அஸ்யூம் பண்ணி நம்ம flow ஆற கரண்ட் என்னது அப்படிங்கறது வந்து we can easily find out. So இது ரெண்டையும் ஆட் பண்ற வேல்யூ வந்து I dash உம் I double dash உம் ஆட் பண்ற வேல்யூ வந்து it should be equal with the current which will be flowing in the 6 ohm resistor. Okay va, so that is the things we can able to use it in the superposition theorem. Okay va, so simple thing ஆ இருக்கும். Just removing one source and keep it in one source. இதே இது மூணு சோர்ஸ் நாலு சோர்ஸ் இருந்தாலும் ஒரு டைம்ல வந்து ஒரு சோர்ஸ் தான் நம்ம வந்து அஸ்யூம் பண்ணி வாட் இஸ் தி வேல்யூ அப்படிங்கறத வந்து ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணனும். ஓகேவா? And this one is the second example. Using superposition theorem, determine the voltage drop and current across the 3.3 ohm. Okay, so here we are having two voltage sources. ஓகேவா? ரெண்டு voltage sources இருக்குது. சோ அத வச்சு voltage source drop என்னது அதே மாதிரி கரண்ட் அக்ராஸ் 3.3 ஓம் என்னது அப்படிங்கறது வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணனும். சரியா? சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டெப் வந்து சோ இந்த சைடு 8 ஓம் 8 வோல்ட்ன்றது வந்து just we are just short circuit it and we are going to calculate the voltage across the 3.3 ஓம். ஓகே, சோ 3.3 ஓம் க்கு வந்து அக்ராஸா என்ன வோல்டேஜ் இருக்கு அப்படிங்கறது வந்து we are going to calculate. சரியா? சோ இதுல என்னன்னு பாத்தீங்கன்னா நதிங் பட் ஓகேவா, சோ இதுல பர மூணு ரெசிஸ்டர் வேல்யூ போட்டுருக்காங்க. ஓகேவா, சோ இது வந்து 2.0 ஓம் 2 கிலோ ஓம் 3.3 கிலோ ஓம் ரெண்டும் வந்து என்னது பேரலல் கனெக்ஷன்ல அவேலபிளா இருக்கு. ஓகேவா, சோ அப்ப இதுல என்ன வோல்டேஜ் சோர்ஸ் நமக்கு கிடைக்குதோ அதே வோல்டேஜ் சோர்ஸ் இத வந்து இங்க அஸ்யூம் பண்ணி டிராப் பண்ணி அஸ்யூம் பண்ணிக்கோங்க. ஓகேவா, சோ அப்ப ரெண்டுமே வந்து பேரலலா இருக்கும். சோ இங்க என்ன வோல்டேஜ் சோர்ஸ் இருக்குதோ அதே வோல்டேஜ் சோர்ஸ் தான் இட் will be கலெக்டட் அக்ராஸ் 2.2 கிலோ ஓம் ஆல்சோ. ஏனா ரெண்டுமே வந்து parallel, in parallel resistor the voltage will be same. Okay va, so you just simplify these terms. Okay va, before you are find out the voltage drop you just simplify 2 parallel 3.3 ohm. Okay, so 2 into 3.3 divided by 2 plus 3.3. so from this we can able to calculate at the equivalent resistor, so that is the value is 1.245 kilo ohm. Okay, suppose இந்த ரெண்டு ரெசிஸ்டருக்கு பதிலா வந்து we can use the 1.245 kilo ohm. Okay, another resistor we are having 4.7 kilo ohm and one voltage source. So அப்ப அதுல இருந்து we can use the voltage division rule. Okay va, so 1.245 க்கு voltage division rule என்னது அப்படிங்கறத வந்து find out பண்ணி parallel substitute பண்ணி we can able to find out the value of V1. So simple thing now. அப்ப பார்த்தாலே உங்களுக்கு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆயிடும். சரியா? So next one we are using the next two voltage source. Okay, so 8 kilo ohm use பண்றோம். So 4 kilo ohm வந்து we are just sorry 5 voltage வந்து we are just short circuited. Okay. So here also the same thing. So 3.3 and 4.7 are connected in parallel. The same voltage source which will be connected across the collected across the these two resistor. Okay. So அதனால வந்து simplify பண்ணி parallel-ஆ இருக்க simplify பண்ணீங்கன்னா 1.938 kilo ohm கிடைக்கும். So just apply the voltage division rule. Voltage division rule apply பண்ணீங்கன்னா what is the voltage value அப்படிங்கறத வந்து find out பண்ணிக்கலாம். ஃபைனலா வந்து ரெண்டையும் ஆட் பண்ணீங்கன்னா we can able to get the voltage drop across the resistor 3.3 kilo ohm வந்து நமக்கு வந்து கிடைக்கும். ஓகேவா? If you are using the two voltage sources, ரெண்டு voltage sources யூஸ் பண்ணி என்ன voltage வந்து across கிடைக்கும் அப்படிங்கறத வந்து we can able to identify. சரியா? So this is one simple thing. So இது மட்டும் தான். ஓகேவா? So ஏதாவது ஒரு source மட்டும் we need to consider. Either it will be a voltage source or current source. Yeah, so ellaa ore idha assume pannite next one vandu we just want to cut it off. Seriya? Idhula edha doubt iruka regarding superposition theorem? Any doubt in this? Okay, really no. Any other? Okay, so if you have no doubt in this, we can okay, so next one is maximum power transfer theorem. Okay, so this is also one of the important thing and it is somewhat simple also, so not the tedious one. So generally we can able to calculate the power using a circuit. Okay, so if you are using any of the circuit means and last problem also we have seen that thing. Okay, so what is the power which will be collected across the source, which will be delivered from the source. Okay, so that is the question we are able to solve. Okay, so we solve the things and find out the value of the power. Okay, so that is one of the thing. And like this, what is the maximum power transfer? Okay, so for this we just need to need the procedure of the Thevenin's theorem. Okay, so through the Thevenin's theorem we can able to solve this thing also. Okay, the same procedure which will be continue for this also. Okay, so for this we need to find out the voltage, Thevenin's voltage and Thevenin's resistance, and from that we can able to calculated the total maximum power, that is maximum power transfer to the load. Okay, so that is the thing. For this you don't want to convince, the one point we just want to keep it in mind is here the Thevenin's as well as the load voltage will be equal. So that is the thing. So once we are considering this value as equal, then only we can able to find out the maximum power which will be delivered. Okay, so this is the thing. So you just want to memorize this formula alone. Okay, so in the formula mattum nama memorize panna porom. So adu eppadi vandichu enna yaadengradha vandu munnadi illa kuduthirupanga, so adala theriyave kedaiyadhu. You just memorize this formula. So we know that we just use this formula for the source resistance. P V-square R நமக்கு தெரியும் சோ இந்த ஃபார்முலாஸ்ல இருந்து how we can able to simplify this term அப்படிங்கறத this is the max maximum power which will be transferred so this is the formula you just need to memorize okay that is dth square divided by 4 rl okay so rl rth it will be same ரெண்டுமே வந்து same condition தான் so அதனால ஒரு பிரச்சனை கிடையாது we need to just substitute the values if you find out the value of V Thevenin Thevenin's voltage and if we know the value of RTH and RL automatically we can able to calculate the maximum power transfer value okay so that is the thing and so this is first example find the value of RL for maximum power transfer to RL okay find the value of RL for maximum power transfer okay so automatically we just want to find out the value of V Thevenin okay so Thevenin's voltage find out பண்ணனும் அப்படினா automatically we know that we just want to remove the load resistance okay so load resistance remove பண்ணனும் so remove பண்ணிட்டு so அதுல இருந்து VTH RTH value வந்து find out பண்ணனும் okay வா so VTH RTH value find out பண்ணிட்டோம் அப்படினா automatically power transfer theorem la we can able to substitute okay so adula irundha namakku theriyum oralavu so if you are removing this rth we can able to get the what is the voltage drop across the 50 ohm give a voltage drop across the 50 ohm kandupidichona that is the V Thevenin okay we are just using the voltage division rule vera edhume kedaiyadhu okay va so vth so iduk across 150 ku across venum appadina v into that is 360 into 150 divided by 150 plus 30 180 so this is the voltage division rule so from that we can able to find out the Thevenin's voltage okay so another one if you want to calculate the resistor RTH means we know that we just want to simply short circuit the voltage source okay so short circuit the voltage source and these resistor are connected in parallel from this we can able to see so after removing this thing so don't consider this it will be automatically removed okay so it will be connected in parallel so we are just using that formula okay so 150 into 30 divided by 150 plus 30 so automatically we can get the Thevenin's resistance okay so VTH and RTH okay so once you just find out the value automatically you can substitute the or rearrange the circuit okay so that is VTH RTH and RL okay so VTH we know that we just calculated and RTH also we know that and RL will be placed okay so we know that RL is equal to RTH that is the condition first condition we have seen it in the maximum power transfer இவ RTH தெரிஞ்சிச்சு அப்படினா RL பத்தி கவலையே வேண்டாம் that is RL RTH is equal to RL okay so just substitute in the formula okay so if you are they have calculated if you are asked to calculate the maximum power transfer means so just substitute in the formula so no need to use this formula okay so in the formula use பண்ணலனாலும் பரவாயில்ல you just work out with that formula okay so P is equal to VTH square divided by 4RL so alla potu paathala ungalku the same 900 watt da varum okay va so adanal vandu eppovume padikiradha andha formula vai padichukom so P is equal to formula theriyum nadakira VTH square divided by 4RL RTH is equal to RL namakku yerkane therinjirukka so just substituting that formula you can get this value 900 watt in the value la namakku vandu kedaikum seriya so adanal vandu if you are good in Thevenin's so Thevenin's voltage Thevenin resistance means automatically easily you can find out the what is the power transfer maximum power transfer to the load resistance okay va so it is somewhat easy ah irukku nu nambara idhula edha doubt iruka so don't use this formula you just use the general standard formula that one okay so VTH square divided by 4RL so that is the standard formula for calculating the maximum power transfer okay so is there any doubt டவுட் இருக்கா மேம்? மேக்ஸிமம் பவர் டிரான்ஸ்ஃபர். அதர்வைஸ் யூ ஜஸ்ட் சா அனதர் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆல்சோ அண்ட் யூ ஜஸ்ட் ஆஸ்க் வெதர் எனி டவுட் இஸ். சோ ஃபைண்ட் தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் லோட் ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆர் இஸ் ஷோன் இன் தி ஃபிகர் தட் கிவ்ஸ் மேக்ஸிமம் பவர் டிசிபேஷன் அண்ட் டிட்டர்மைன் தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் திஸ் பவர். Value of RL means automatically we need to find out the RTH. RTH kandupidicha RL value therinjirum and maximum power dissipation determine the value of power. Okay, so we need to find out the value of the power by using that formula. Okay, and the first thing we just want to calculate the heat terminates. Okay, so for that we just want to short circuit at the RL. Okay, so short circuit panikonga. So whatever the resistance, sorry, whatever the voltage drop which will be collected across 12 ohm, so that is the VTH value. Okay, we can able to use the ordinary voltage division formula. Okay, adha use pannikalam rendume vandu pathinga appadina so series connection la irukku, so from this we can able to use the voltage division formula. Okay, so P total voltage into so 12 divided by 12 plus 3, that is the VTH. And we are calculating the resistance RTH value. For this we just want to short circuit this voltage. Okay, so we need to short circuit this voltage and the remaining we are having these two resistor in parallel, 12 and 3, which will be connected in parallel. So by using the formula A into B divided by A plus B, we can able to find out the RTH value. So once RTH is find means that is the value of RL2. Okay, so RL value na adhe RTH value and we just use the power dissipation formula. Okay, so P is equal to VTH square divided by 4RL. Okay, so just substitute with that formula. So in the formula use pannalum adhe dhaan varum, idhukku I la vandhu nama thaniya kandupidikkiradhukku we can able to use that formula. Okay, so P is equal idhula vandhu so finally I value la calculate panni nama vandhu indha formula use pandrom. So instead of he automatically calculating VTH RTH, okay, adu rendu calculate pandranaala we can use that formula P is equal to VTH square divided by 4RL. okay, so you can able to get the 15 watt. Okay, so it is somewhat easy, we just want to know how to find out the value of VTH RTH and we need to know the formula for maximum power transfer. Okay, so that is the thing we need to keep. Next, we are moving to next one. So if you have any doubt in maximum power transfer, maximum power transfer is a doubt program. There are doubt irukka ma'am, packet solunga yes or no anything. Excuse me. நிகேஷ் இங்கில இருக்கியா? இதாம நிகேஷ் இருக்கியா? நிகேஷ் Interview on my criminal okay, so next we move into the sir. Okay, so just move and quickly go through the remaining things. So next one is the network, so two port network. Okay, so this is the terms which will be related to the impedance and admittance. So how the networks can be connected and how the ports will be connected in a network, like that we are having the things. Okay. So we are having two ports means definitely it will be having the input as well as the output ports. Okay, so two ports will be available. Alvin, in the edukana uttu oru adha round attend panni irupanga nadaiya amma adhu CDC vandhuchi amma sir adha next round check panni poirupanga appingiradha nadha sonnanga paathukanga adhala edukana uttu oru padikadhinga appdi வீட் நம்பர் இருந்துச்சுனா லைட்டா வந்து கேட்டேன் அப்படி அத்தனை மணிக்கு இருக்கான மட்டும் கேட்டு சொல்லு அத்தனை மணிக்கு இருக்காங்க அப்படியே விட்டுரு. So this is the next one. We are having the port networks. Okay, so we are having the input as well as the output port. So this is the two port network, then this is the one port network. We are having two terminals in one thing. So this is termed as one port. Okay, so in the other side also we are having the two network. We are having the two lines means it is also called as the one port. Okay, So this is will be having mainly used to do transferring the things. Okay, so transferring the energy or transferring the signal. So that is the main application of the two port network. So for example, we can able to see the transformers. Okay, so transformers we can able to see the things. Okay, so one end is connected with the AC and another end is connected with the circuits. Okay, so it just stepped off. So we are having the two terminals at the one end and two terminals at the another end. Okay, so that is one of the best example for the two port network. So in case of transmission line and amplifiers, filters, electronic circuits, so whatever the things, so we are provided with two terminals at one end and another two terminals, the signals will get vary. Okay, so whatever the signal which will be coming to the component and just performing the process and it does just deliver the signals over the output ports. Okay, so that is the example for the two port networks. Okay, and so this is some of the things. And this is the parameters for the two port network. So while we are considering a port network, so two port network means we just want to consider the, these are some of the parameters. So we just want to know the, what is the impedance value present at the input port as well as the output port. Okay, so that is the thing we need to have it in consideration. So this is the things we just having the parameters. Okay, so impedance, admittance and hybrid parameters. So these are the basic things we can able to know. Okay, so we just undergone these kind of parameters. Impedance, we know that. Admittance is nothing but the inverse of the impedance. And the hybrid parameters, nothing but the Z and Y. So these are the, combinedly, you can able to have the hybrid parameter. And G is the conductance, which is the inverse of the H, hybrid parameter. Okay, so these are the some of the parameters we need to consider while designing the port network. Okay, and in case of transmission line, we are having just ABCD parameters. So it is the basic thing only. Okay. So this is the first one we are going to discuss about the Z parameters. Okay, so I just go through the basic thing and what are the important points we need to having, just mention that. Okay, so this is the diagramic representation of the impedance parameter. Okay, so if it is having the, it is a Z parameter means, and that is the impedance parameter, and the input we are having, input and output which will be mentioned as 1 and 2. Okay, so if this is the input side, we are having the flow of current 1 and voltage as V1. And this is the output side, output port. We are having the current I2 and V2. Okay, so this is the diagrammatic representation of all this. Okay, so for impedance calculation, we are having 4 types of impedance. Okay, so that's what are the possible thing means. Z11, Z12, Z22, Z21. Okay. So Z11 is the input impedance and Z12 is the input to output impedance and Z22 is output impedance and Z21 is output to input impedance. Okay, so whatever the numbers mentioned at the end, initial, okay, initial and at the first and second thing. Okay, so first and second the place, it will be having like that. Okay, so first time we are having the 1 means it will be mentioned as input. And the second one, we are having the 2 means it will mention as output. Okay. Likewise, 1-1 means it is differently, wholly depend upon the input impedance value. And 2-2 means it is wholly depend upon the output impedance value. Okay. So this is the conditions for the condition or diagrammatic representation for the impedance parameter. Okay. So in case of two port network. So the, here we are having the general equation. You just need to memorize this equation for Z parameter. Okay. So that is the, this is the important one. So what is the voltage at the input port and what is the voltage at the output port? Okay, so the voltage at the input port is mentioned as V1, which is equal to, we know that V is equal to I into R. Okay, so in case of a system, we are using the impedance. Okay, so in case of input, Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. Okay, so in case of voltage at the input side. So in case of voltage at the output side, V2 is equal to Z21I1 plus Z22I2. Okay, so this is the two equation for the two port network in case of input and output ports. Okay, so this is some of the important points, and from this important equation we are need to calculate the, or we need to find out the value of this impedance parameter Z11, Z22, Z21 and Z22. So these are the four equations. So our four values we are going to find out for any of the short circuit network. Okay, so that open circuit network. Okay, so another one name for Z parameter is open circuit parameter. Okay, so you just keep in mind, whenever the question is asked from this, they have also mentioned as Z parameter or open circuit parameter. Okay, so if they are mentioned as open circuit parameter, you just want to find out the impedance parameter only, Z11, Z12, Z21 and Z22. So in case if it is mentioned as short circuit parameter, means that is Y parameter, you need to find out the parameters as Y11, Y12, Y21 and Y22. So yeah, so these are the basic overview for this. And if you are substituting I2 in equation, I2 equal to 0. Okay, so we are substituting I2 is equal to 0 in equation 1. Okay, so if you are substituting I2 is equal to 0, means the term gets 0. Remaining is V1 is equal to Z11I1. So from this we can able to identify the value Z11. So Z11 is equal to V1 divided by I1. That is the value of Z1. So in case of if you are substituting I2 is equal to 0 in equation 2, means we can find out the value of Z21. So Z21 equal to V2 divided by I1. Okay, so you can see this. If you are substituting I2 in equation 1, you can get the value of Z11. And in case of I2 equal to 0 in equation 2, you can get the value of Z21 equal to V2 divided by I1 in case of I2 equal to 0. Okay, so this is the conditions. Like that, if you are putting I1 equal to 0 in equation 1 and 2, okay, I1 on this 0 on the equation 1 and 2 la vandu substitute pannom appadina namakku theriyum indha term cancel aayidum. So appo idu mattum dhaan irukum. Z12 is equal to V1 divided by I2. Like this, equation 2 la I1 0 potom appadina indha term cancel aayidum. Z22 is equal to V2 divided by I2. Okay, these are the four parameters we need to know the equation. Okay, so in the values vandu namakku kandipa theriyum. So epovume idhula irundhu neenga easier therinjikkuradhu eppadi panikalam appadina r equal to v by a, z equal to v by a namakku theriyum. So 1 1 irundhuchna na 1 1, okay, voltage la 1, current la 1. So in case of 2 1 irundhuchna voltage la 2, current la 1. Okay, in case of 1 2 irundhuchna voltage la 1, current la 2. So z22 irundhuchna voltage la 2, current la 2. Okay, so idha vachi simple ah vandu memorize panni vechukonga. Okay, va ena over thani nama substitute panni what is the value அப்படிங்கறத find out பண்ண முடியாது. So you just memorize like this. Okay, so Z12 means V1 divided by I2. So Z22 means V2 divided by I2. Z12 means V1 divided by I2. Z11 means V1 divided by I2. Okay, so these are the four parameters you just need to keep it in mind. Okay, and this is the thing. So this how we can able to expect the problems. Okay, for a two port network, measurements are made and observation as below. Okay, they have just mentioned two port network, and measurements made and observe as below. That's the thing. Okay, they didn't mention any of the parameters till now. Okay, so with output terminal pair open. Okay, so this is the point we need to understand. Okay, so with output terminal pair open, okay, so upon that is a open circuit. So open circuit means nothing but the impedance parameter only. We need to find out the impedance parameter. Okay, wow. So with output terminal pair open, a voltage of 100 angle theta through the input port. So input port means we can able to get the voltage. Voltage is mentioned by the input port. So it is nothing but V1. Okay, wow. So the wording said there, you need to understand the things. Okay. And the remaining I1 directly they have mentioned, and V2 directly they have mentioned. Okay, wow. So next one, with the input terminal pair open. Here also they have mentioned it is open. Okay, so here also we are going to calculate the impedance value. So impedance parameter we are going to calculate. Okay, the same voltage applied to the output terminal. Okay, the same voltage applied to the output terminal. Okay, va. So, appo idhula irundhum nama vandu identify pannikalam. Output terminal ku vandu same voltage dhaan apply pandranga. So, inge pathinga na voltage vandu 100 volt, 100 angle theta nu koduthirukanga. The same voltage applied to the output terminal. Okay, va. Apply output terminal la vandu V2 value vandu it is 100 angle theta 0. Sorry, 100 angle 0 degree. Okay, va. And I2 they have specifically mentioned and I1 they have specifically mentioned. Okay. So now we know the all the parameters. Okay. I1, I2, V1, V2, all the things we can able to know. Okay. So idhula irundhu paathinga appadina output terminal. Okay. So output terminal open la irukku appadina we just want to calculate at the input parameters. Okay. So Z11 and Z12. So in the parameters vachi find out panna vendiya value. அதே இது இன்புட் டெர்மினல் ஓபனா இருந்துச்சுன்னா வி ஜஸ்ட் வாண்ட் டு கால்குலேட் அட் தி அவுட்புட் பேராமீட்டர்ஸ் Z22 Z21 அந்த ரெண்டு வேல்யூ இந்த ஃபார்முலாஸ் இந்த டேட்டாஸ் வச்சு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணுவோம் ஓகேவா ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் திங் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு கால்குலேட் ஃபார் திஸ் அவுட்புட் டெர்மினல் ஓபன் அப்படின்னா வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு தி கால்குலேட் அட் தி இன்புட் பேராமீட்டர் Z11 அண்ட் Z12 ஸோ வி நோ தி ஃபார்முலா Z11 ஈக்குவல் டு V1 டிவைடட் பை I1 ஸோ V1 தே ஹவ் மென்ஷன்ட் அஸ் 100 அண்ட் I1 தே ஹவ் மென்ஷன்ட் அஸ் 20 ஸோ ஃப்ரம் திஸ் easily find out the value of Z11. So as another one is Z12. So Z12 means V1 divided by I2. Okay, so we know the value of the V1 and we know the value of the I2 also. Okay, so I2 also it will be mentioned as 20 ampere. Okay, so it will be having the things and from this we can able to find out the 2 ohm. Okay, so already Z21, so V2 divided by I1. Okay, so V2 value already we know that V2 is equal to 25 and V1 is already we know that it is given as 20 ohm. Sorry, I1. Okay, so I1 it is mentioned as 20 ohm. Okay, so other end வந்து நம்ம வந்து calculate பண்ணிக்கலாம். So இதுல இருந்து 1.25 value நம்ம வந்து get பண்ணிக்கலாம். Likewise Z22 value நமக்கு வந்து find out பண்றதுக்கு V2 divided by I2 that is the formula. V2 value வந்து நமக்கு ஏற்கனவே அவங்க mention பண்ணிருக்காங்க. The same voltage applied to the output. Okay, so the same voltage means the 100 voltage will be applied to the output. So we know the value of V2 and I2 is already mentioned as 20 angle theta degree 0. So that also mentioned here and also find out the parameters Z11, Z12, Z21 and Z22. Okay, so from the problems we need to identify what are all the parameters they have mentioned. And what are all the values we need to find out and what are all the parameters we are going to find out enna idu abingiradhu vandu by means of this impedance or admittance abingiradhu vandu by means of open circuit or short circuit abingiradhu vachi la vandu we need to calculate okay va and this is one example for this after calculating Z11 Z12 Z21 Z22 you just substitute in this equation okay va namak general equation I already know that V1 equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. So just substitute and get the generalized equation for this condition. Okay, va? So this is about the impedance parameters. Is there any doubt in this? Next we are going to see about the admittance parameter. Lega doubt irukka for impedance parameter. So once you go through these slides means you can easily understand this. Okay. So I just send this overall PPT. Okay. So yesterday's class, last class and this class also I just met the topics. I just sent the whole PPT to you and once or twice you just go through the things and you can understand the things. You just fight on your own. Okay, so if you are having any, if you understand anything means you just write it in any of the notes. Okay, note will be achala, konjama namakku vandu understand aagum, so thirumbi paakumbodhu. So once if you are going through PPT all the time means you can't able to understand everything. So from the PPT, whatever you have data, you understand, you just mention in your note and you can go through it twice or thrice, therefore at the regular interval of time. Okay, so there is no queries. Next we move into the admittance. Okay. That is Y parameter. Okay, so Y parameter or short circuit parameter. So you just keep it in mind. Z parameter means it is open circuit parameter, and Y parameter means it is a short circuit parameter. Okay, and this is the representation for the diagram representation for the input and output. The same thing only. There will not be any change. Not much change in this. And the input, they have mentioned the port as Y11. And from input to output, they have mentioned as Y12, and output port they have mentioned as Y22, and output to input Y21. The same current and voltage will be mentioned in the input, and I2, V2 is the same current which will be provided at the output. Okay. And regarding the equation, we have just find out the voltage value. Okay, so V1 and V2, these are the two equations we have just shortlisted or get from that equation, from the diagram. Okay, so here we are calculating the current. Okay, so I1 and I2. So I1 equal to, so we already know that. So V is equal to I into R. Okay, so R for Z impedance, we are just replacing R by Z. Okay, so in the pathing of the current, we know the formula I equal to V by R. Okay. So I equal to V by R na. So we know that the relation between Y and Z. So Y is equal to 1 by Z. Okay, so automatically 1 by Z and put on na, V divided by Z, that is the condition. Okay, so 1 by Z, instead of 1 by Z, we have mentioned it as Y11. Okay, so that is the relationship between. So if you have any doubt, you just use this. Okay, so in the Maria options you use panni think panni na, you can generally write this equation clearly. Okay. So I1 is equal to V1 into Y11. So plus V2 into Y12. The same thing. Okay, so I2 is equal to Y21 V1 plus Y22 V2. Okay, va? Adhe maradha irukum. Just the difference is anga inga V1 and irukum. So equation V1 and irukum. Inga I1 and irukum, I2 and irukum. So inga vandu V1 V2 and irukku avladha. மற்றபடி அங்க ஒய்க்கு பதிலாக இசட் அதே ஈக்குவேஷன் தான். ஓகேவா? ஸோ தேர் வில் நாட் பி எனி சேஞ்ச் இன் திஸ். ஸோ யூ கேன் யூஸ் திஸ் ஈக்குவேஷன் பை ஹேவிங் திஸ் இன் மைண்ட். ஓகே. அண்ட் ஹியர் ஆல்சோ த சேம் கண்டிஷன் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு அப்ளை. ஸோ இஃப் யூ ஆர் அப்ளைங் V1 ஈக்குவல் டு 0 இன் ஈக்குவேஷன் 7 அண்ட் 8. ஓகே, ஸோ இன் திஸ் ஈக்குவேஷன் 7 அண்ட் 8, வி ஆர் ஜஸ்ட் சப்ஸ்டியூட்டிங் V1 ஈக்குவல் டு 0 அண்ட் வி கேன் ஏபிள் டு கெட் தி வேல்யூ ஆஃப் Y12. Y12 இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு I1 divided by V2. That is the equation we can be able to get from this. While we are substituting V1 equal to 0 in equation 8, there will not be any value for this. And Y22 is equal to I2 divided by V2. Okay, so this is the equations we can be able to derive. Okay, va? Likewise, if you are applying V1 and V2 equal to 0, and the remaining values we can be able to identify. Okay, so V1, V2 to 0 put on, then all values are there. Y11, Y12, Y21 and Y22. So these are all the conditions we can able to get from that. Okay. And here also we can able to expect the problem like this. Okay. So for example, this is the one. For a two-port network, measurements are made and observed as below. Here they have mentioned with output terminal pair, short circuited. So they have mentioned it as short circuited. So from this we can identify it is a Y parameter. Okay, va? So admittance parameter of the ground, we can identify through this short circuited. Okay. And your voltage is given. Okay, your voltage of 15 angle 0 degree through the input port, that is V1. Okay. Resulting in I1 equal to 2 angle 0. And I2 is equal to -1 ampere. So next condition, with input terminal short circuited. So that is input terminal short circuited. We are going to calculate at the output port. Okay, the voltage of 12 angle 0 degree applied to the output terminal. That is V2 value. Okay, V2 is equal to 12 angle 0 degree, and I1 and I2 they have mentioned. Okay, so these are the given datas. So from this we need to calculate the Y11, Y12, Y21 and Y22. Okay, by the equation mentioned from that. Okay, so V2 equal to 0 and what on the NLA kadaikyam, V1 equal to 0 and what on the NLA kadaikyam, we can identify the things. Yeah. So we know the formula Y11 equal to I1 divided by G1. So V2 value on the mention pannirukka maatanga, V2 is equal to 0. So here on the path alayam we thiriyam. So here on the voltage of 50 angle 0 through the input port. Appa V1 irukku. Okay, V1 irukku, I1 irukku, I2 irukku. V2 value illa. Appa V2 is equal to 0. V2 equal to 0 nu potta enna equation namak kadaikum. And the equation la indha sub values vandu substitute pannu. Okay, va. So likewise the we are calculating for the impedances also. Okay, va. Impedances ku idhe maari dhaan. Adhiliyum paathinga appadina I1 la I1 value vandu oru condition la irukadhu. I2 value vandu oru condition la irukadhu. Okay, va. அது கண்டிஷன் இல்லாத டைம்ல ஜீரோ போட்டோம்னா என்ன பேராமீட்டர்ஸ் நமக்கு கிடைக்குதோ அந்த பேராமீட்டர்ஸை யூஸ் பண்ணி வி ஜஸ்ட் யூட்டிலைஸ் தட் ஃபார்முலா. ஓகேவா? ஸோ அதில் வேல்யூ சப்ஸ்டியூட் பண்ணி Z11, Z12 அந்த மாதிரி கண்டிஷன்ஸ் வந்து கால்குலேட் பண்ணுவோம். சரியா? அதே மாதிரி தான் இங்கேயும் V2 வேல்யூ ஜீரோ போட்டோம்னா ரெண்டு ஈக்குவேஷன்லயும் நமக்கு வந்து என்ன கிடைக்கும்? ஓகேவா? ஸோ Y11 கிடைக்கும், Y21 கிடைக்கும். Y11 வேல்யூ என்னது, Y21 வேல்யூ, எல்லாமே மோல். ஓகேவா? ஸோ யூனிட்ஸ் வந்து மோ, இம்பிடன்ஸுக்கு வந்து ஓம், ஸோ அட்மிட்டன்ஸுக்கு வந்து மோ. ஓகேவா? அதே மாதிரி V1 ஈக்குவல் டு 0 போட்டோம் அப்படின்னா வாட் வில் பி தி வேல்யூஸ்? ஓகேவா? ஸோ அதில் வந்து Y12, Y22 வேல்யூஸ் வந்து ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணி வி கேன் கால்குலேட் தி திங்ஸ். ஓகேவா? ஸோ சிம்பிள் திங் ஒன்லி. ஸோ இட்ஸ் நாட் அ டிவியஸ் ஒன். வி ஜஸ்ட் வாண்ட் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆர் மெமரைஸ் தி ஈக்குவேஷன் இஸ் நெசசரி. What is the value for V1 and V2 for impedance? And what is the value for, what is the equation for I1 and I2 for admittance? Okay, once you are good in that equation, you can solve easily. Okay, so you can get the formulas also very easily once substituting the value. V1 equal to 0 and V2 equal to 0, what is the value? Likewise, in the impedance, I1 equal to 0, I2 equal to 0, what is the value? Okay. So from this you can able to get the values of Y11, Y12, Y22, Y21. Okay, so this is the basic parameters value we can able to identify through the Y parameters. Okay, and the next one is the hybrid parameter. You just mention the equation, that is enough. Okay, so if you are doing just memorize the equation, okay, by having any hint in me, okay, so without hint or you just memorize the equation. Okay, so generally V1 under this now Z11, Z12, or they did V2 under this now Z21, Z22. Likewise, in the admittance, I1 under this now Y11, Y12. I2 under this now Y21, Y22. Okay, so likewise, so just if you have a hint in the equation and keep it in mind. And hybrid parameters means we are having voltage as well as the current. Okay, well, voltage equation or current equation. Okay, well, so rendering combined hybrid, nothing but the combination of the impedance as well as the admittance value. Okay, well. So impedance and admittance combined madradha vandu hybrid parameters. Okay, va. So from this we can calculate the V1 and I2. Okay, so these are the two equations we can able to come across from that. Okay, so V1 is equal to instead of impedance and admittance we can able to use the parameter H. Okay, so it's not mentioning Z or Y, we are using the hybrid parameter H. Okay, like that V1 equal to H11I1 plus H12V2, or I2 is equal to H21I1 plus H22V2. So this is the two equation you need to memorize for the hybrid parameter. Okay, so here also the same thing you can able to memorize. So V1 first eduthirukom appadina H11 H12 தான் வரும் ஓகேவா சோ அங்கேயும் அதே மாதிரி தான் கண்டிஷன்ஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் இது கரண்ட் செகண்ட் இது வோல்டேஜ் லைக் வைஸ் I2 எடுத்துக்கிட்டோம்னா H21 H22 அதே மாதிரி தான் அங்கேயும் ஓகேவா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கரண்ட் அடுத்து வோல்டேஜ் லைக் திஸ் யூ ஜஸ்ட் மெமரைஸ் இன் யுவர் மைண்ட் ஓகேவா And here also we are just substituting the values. I1 equal to 0 now, what will be the answer? H12 and H22 we can able to get. Okay. In case of and V2 is equal to 0. If you are substituting V2 is equal to 0 means what is the value of H21 and H21 and H21. Okay. So these are the two values we can able to get from while substituting V2 is equal to 0. Okay, so and also just keep in mind in this values also if H21 is H21 it is called as short circuit forward current gain H11 it is a input impedance and H22 it is a open circuit output admittance okay so likewise you just have a wordings also okay so in a wordings appear on you just keep it in mind also So these are some of the parameters we can able to identify. Okay, and so this is the first example for this. Find the H parameter for the network. Okay, so solution we just want to make the output port as short circuit one. Okay, so V2 is equal to 0 means what will be the equation we can able to get? Okay, so V2 is equal to 0 means what will be the equation we can able to get from the equation? You just have the parameters H11 and what is the value for that. Okay, so are they very and like that for H21. Okay, so H11 and H21 and here they have mentioned the current. Okay, so the current which will be flowing in the opposite direction once we are considering. Okay, so I1, I2 value on this which will be flowing in the opposite direction. Okay, so once you find out the H21 and H11, you just mention the current in that also. Give us I2 is equal to minus I1. So once we have calculated the current I1, then we can able to use that current also. Okay, so and the current value we use panni, what is the value something you want to find out panni, we can able to find out the values. Give us simply they have mentioned the representation not in the numbers okay so current and representation on the arrow mark representation that they have mentioned okay likewise voltage and current resistor only for resistor only they have mentioned the values okay so now the current flowing conditions of which we can mentioned in the equation okay so we can able to use the If you are using the values means it is somewhat simple. Okay. So every other substitute panni H21 and H12 values and all the figure on there, we just need to identify. Okay. So most probably they have given the values. Okay. So you know, general on there, they have given the parameters name. Okay. So I1, I2, figure of parameters name on the putra panga. So most probably they have mentioned the values for I1 and I2. So it is somewhat simple to substituting the equations prescribed for this. Okay, so another the NI equation put to the other equations from this direct substitution funny answer get from Ramallah, we can able to expect. Okay, and this is regarding the hybrid parameter. So it is also one of the main topic. Okay, so in case of two port network, so once it is a impedance parameter that is open circuit one, and the next one is admittance parameter that is a short circuit parameter. And the final one is the hybrid parameter. Okay, so these are all the parameters which will be considering for the two port network. Okay, so only one thing you just want to have a hint for this equation. Okay, six equations we can nearly get for the three types. You can have the hint for that particular things and keep it in mind. Okay, so if you have any queries for this. Two port network. So two port network. If you have any queries, டவுட் இருக்கா இல்லையா? எல்லாரும் இருக்கீங்களா இல்லையா? சார் நோ ஓகே சோ we are having only one more topics, that is the RL circuit, RLC circuit and RC circuit. So that's the thing, only you just understand by using Laplace theorem. Okay, so once you put in Laplace theorem, you can easily substitute by having the circuits, okay. So before you move into that particular topic, you just go through the Laplace. Okay, so Laplace overlap when you go through panita, you just move into that topic. Okay, so then only it will be useful for you. So then only it can be easily understand also. Okay. So the things will be given. Okay, so what will be regarding the transient state and some of the basic things, you just go through this. Already you have seen in your syllabus also what is transient response and what is natural response. Is nothing but if you are assuming it is a pendulum, okay, so a time will be connected to a ball means without any external, so how it will be get oscillates. Okay, so without giving any external force, how the ball will get oscillated. Okay, so that is the natural response. So in case of if you are applying an external force, okay, so if you are applying an external force, how the oscillation will be happening. Okay, so that is the external response we can able to, force response, that is the thing we can able to identify. Okay, so these are some of the basic things you just need to know. Okay, so natural response as well as the forced response. Okay. So you just go through this. If you are go through this, you can able easily understand the things. Okay, so PA is also mentioned that, and zero input response and zero state response. Okay, so zero input response means where we are not providing any external forces, and how the response will be happening. Okay, so if you are, that is zero input, we are not providing any external forces to any of the system, and what will be the response. Okay, and zero state response means, and by using the arbitrary values, what will be the initial condition will be identically zero. That is the condition. Okay, so initially we are having the initial values as zero. We are calling the arbitrary inputs. That is the zero state response. Okay, that is comes under the natural response also. Okay, and this is one of the topics, and this is one of the important things also we can able to have. So in case of if you are having any RLC networks. Okay, so RL circuit or RLC circuit, and what will be the arrangements and what will be the circuits parameter which will be act. Okay, so at what time? So these are these three parameters we can able to use it for RLC circuit or LC. Okay, so this is the RLC parameters. At time t is equal to zero. Okay, so without giving any input to that particular system. Okay, whatever the circuit, we are providing a system, and if we are mentioning a system, okay, whatever the circuit, if you are not providing any external input at t is equal to zero, okay, so t is equal to zero, we are not providing any external input, and what will be the circuit be like? Okay, at t is equal to zero, the resistor is always having the resistance value, it doesn't get changes. Okay, so at t is equal to zero, the inductance is act like a open circuit. So this is one of the important point. Okay, you need to consider. So t is equal to zero, the inductance will act as a open circuit, and at t is equal to zero, the capacitance will act as a short circuit. Okay, and at t is equal to infinite, resistance is always like that, and inductance will act as a short circuit, and the capacitance will act as a open circuit. Okay, so this is the initial and final value of the network. Okay, so how the initial condition will act as the parameter, that is resistor, inductor and capacitor, and how the final values could be reacted. So that is the values mentioned here. Okay, and Laplace transform, you just go through it. Okay, so then only you can understand this thing. So these are the circuits we can able to have. Okay, so the steady state condition. Okay, so steady state and steady state, you can you just see it in signals and systems also. Okay. Steady state means there will not be any change in the condition. Okay, after the transition period. So once we are applying any external forces, once the oscillation is over, it will be maintained as a steady state. Okay, so that will not be any change in the values. Okay, so that is mentioning the steady state. And while the transition period, once move from one state to another state, that is the unsteady state condition. Okay, so by applying any voltage or current as the external or internal things. Okay, so that is the things we need to consider for the transient response in case of RL, RC and RLC. So RL and RC are the first order equation, and the RLC circuit is the second order equation. Okay, so you just want to keep it in mind also. Okay. And at t is equal to 0, what will be the condition we can able to get? Okay, so we are also calculating the what will be the current flowing in this circuit in case of RLC. Okay, and in case of RC, or in case of RC, RL or RLC. Okay, so the whatever the condition which will be happening. By substituting the value, if it is equal to 0, we know that inductance is open circuit. So open circuit, there will not be any flow of current will be takes place. That is, IF0 is equal to 0. Okay, so these are some of the basic things. So you just need to know the final equation. So that is somewhat important. Okay, so just go through it. And they have final equation, you need to keep it in mind. So this is the final equation we can able to get. I is equal to V by R into 1 minus e power minus RT divided by L. Okay. And VL is equal to, that is the voltage at the load side, V into e power minus RT divided by L. So once we can able to having the values and what much of time period they have mentioned in the problem itself, and you need to substitute in that equation. Okay. So in that equation, you need to substitute the what is the time period they have allocated and what is the response time for the particular system. Like that, they have mentioned the time, you need to substitute in this equation and find out the values for that. Okay, so for this, you need to have a memorize for these equations. Okay, what is the current and what is the load voltage for this? Okay, and like this for RL also. If RL at T is equal to infinite condition, what will be the equation? Okay, so it's just deriving the things, you don't need to go through all the things. You just need to have these equations, final equations for at t is equal to 0 and t is equal to infinite condition, what will be the current value and what will be the voltage at the load side. Okay, so this is the, these are the some of the equations while representing the t is equal to infinite for RL circuit. Okay, and like that they have mentioned the formula problem, like that they have asked the problem also. So they have mentioned the voltage applied to the series RL circuit with R is equal to 25, what will be the current in the circuit at twice the time constant? Okay, so they have mentioned the time as twice the time constant. Okay, so they are asked to calculate the current value. So for this, you need to use the current equation they have mentioned at the last. Okay, so I will derive one final answer for the, you just go through that final formula. You don't need to go through all the derivation part. So I will Laplace equation 1-1 of edit the in the final answer, you just memorize the final formula is enough. Okay, so in this you just substitute the values, we know the value of the voltage as well as the resistance, from that we can able to find out the value of I. Okay, and the current is twice as the time constant time. So t is the constant time and the time which will be required to make the response. Okay, so that is the twice time, twice the constant time. So t is equal to 2t, instead of t you just substitute 2t, from that you can able to calculate the current. Okay, so like that we can expect the problems also. Okay, by using the final equation after using the Laplace equation for that circuit, we can able to get the things. Okay, and for some problems we need to substitute the Laplace equations also. Okay, so by applying KVL to that particular circuit, and for that equation, we need to apply the Laplace equation. And from this, we need to find out the value of the IS. Okay. So for this only, I just mentioned that you just go through the Laplace. Okay, so what is the how the Laplace will be mentioning, so how the values will be mentioning, you just go through it, and after that you just refer this problem. Okay, so I'll go through பண்ணாம நமக்கு வந்து இந்த ப்ராப்ளம் பார்க்கறதுல வந்து அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஆகுறது கொஞ்சம் கஷ்டமா இருக்கும். ஓகேவா? சோ அதனால வந்து எதுக்கு வந்து s into i of s இந்த மாதிரி s square into i of s போடணும் அப்படிங்கறது வந்து கொஞ்சம் கோ த்ரூ பண்ணிட்டு இந்த எக்ஸாம்பிள்ஸ் ப்ராப்ளம் மட்டும் கோ த்ரூ பண்ணுங்க. தட் இஸ் எனஃப். ஓகே. சோ ரிகார்டிங் RL, RC and RLC சர்க்யூட் we are having the problems here. ஓகே, சோ இதுல ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் இருக்கு. அதே மாதிரி RC க்கு we are having the final current as well as the voltage equations. You just write this equation in note. Okay, so note la thaniya the equations la eludhi vechukonga. So once they have asked this type of questions also, they have mentioned the values for this and find out the value of that particular voltage and current at the output. Okay, va andha mari problems kekkalam. Like that circuit kuduthu you just simplify by means of KVL or KCL. Okay, so KVL apply panni applying the Laplace equation and just find out the values from it, we can expect. Okay, so and the mari problems konjam kammiya dhaan varum. Okay, so because we need to solve all the things. Okay, so solve pandrathu konjam time edukumgranaala most probably we can expect the problems by using these formulas. Okay, so RL, RLC, RC adu moonukkum vandu current formula endu voltage formula endungal mattum lighta adu mattum eludhi vechuvom illa kadaisiya idhu mari irukla so indha time la current energy equation voltage energy அப்படிங்கற equations மட்டும் just write it in your note and after that we just verify the problems. Okay, so very Laplace ஏ கொஞ்சம் go through பண்ணிட்டு இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு problems கொஞ்சம் பாத்தீங்கன்னா you can understand the concept very well. Okay, just go through it after just recollect the Laplace condition. Okay, well, Laplace condition go through பண்ணிட்டு after then you just go through it. Okay, so then only it will be somewhat useful for you. So hopefully we just cover all the topics in this. Okay, so maina vandu inda topics ah namakku theriya vendiyadhu and RL RC circuit mattum konjam Laplace paathu paathina you can able to get the ideas. Okay, so most probably this is the thing. Okay, so nodal and mesh analysis, Thevenin theorem, Norton theorem and sinusoidal steady state, that is condition of the initial states la undu sonnadhu. Okay, so the transient period vachu sonnadhu, maximum power transfer and the time and frequency domain of RL, RLC and RLC circuit. Okay, and Laplace transform, solution of a network equation using Laplace transform, linear two port network and way to delta, that is star to delta transformation. Okay, so most probably we just cover all the topics in this syllabus. Okay, most importantly we need to concentrate this also. Okay, so node and mesh analysis, Thevenin's and Norton's theorem and linear two port network, star to delta and RL, RC, RLC, this is the last option. Okay, so and the maximum power transfer also we can expect. Okay, so go through these topics and go through these slides, and if you have any problems, if you have any doubt, means you can ask at any time, and just go through some of the problems to just work out. If you have any circuits or gate related questions, means you just refer the circuit first, you don't see the answer initially. Okay, so what is the answer initially, you just don't check with that and you just think how we can able to solve the circuit, that is the main thing. You just need to get a concept so we can able to solve this method, mesh or nodal. So what is the simple method? So for this you need to solve more problems. Okay, so go through that repeatedly and solve this circuit related. So once you are good in circuit related, you can easily get more marks in this syllabus. Okay, so networks related things we can able to get more ideas regarding this. Okay, so if you have any queries you can see the things. Otherwise we have 3 more games, you can write up in session at 1 o'clock. Any query regarding this, we'll send the PPT. Okay, so I have sent to Suresh sir and he will share it in your gate group. Okay, otherwise for 5 years I will send to you any other method mode or any other things. For the 3rd year also I just send whatever the mode it may be required. Okay, so if you have any queries you can ask. 3 more minutes. Whether it is useful for all of you, about any content you guys get from this? Yes, okay. So remaining thing is in your hand. You need to solve more questions, then only you can get more ideas. Okay, so I just mentioned what are all the possible methods and what are the possible sites we can able to solve the problems. Okay, so for the remaining things, you need to solve more questions regarding the circuits. Okay, so then only you can get more ideas regarding that. And regarding these questions, these are some of the questions we have already seen in the problem itself. Okay. So if there are no queries, means I just switch over to Suresh sir. Okay. Okay, Andrew sir, anything you need to inform to the students? Andrew sir or Suresh sir?